स्क्रीन लॉट आ रहा है। गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द नेशनल वेबिनार ऑन लोकल सेल्फ गवर्नमेंट्स एंड सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गुड प्रैक्टिसेस फ्रॉम केरला। दिस इज द थर्ड ऑफ द सीरीज ऑन दिस वेबिनार सीरीज। अर्लियर वी हैड थीम्स ऑन एग्रीकल्चर, वाटर कंजर्वेशन एंड नाउ वी आर एक्चुअली मूविंग ऑन टू child friendly local governance. Here we should all remember that as part of the People's Plan campaign, many areas dealing with social justice and social protection and all were actually considered by the local self governments in Kerala, and one of them was on child friendly local governance. In fact, the plan guidelines itself speaks about a mandatory 5% to be earmarked for child related activities. Now for this webinar today, we are fortunate to have our honorable Minister for Health, Social Justice and Women and Child Development, Srimati Shailaja Teacher, with us. She will inaugurate the webinar today. Welcome, Shailaja Teacher. We have with us seven local governments. We have Vallapattanam Gram Panchayat from Kannur. We have Peravur Gram Panchayat from Kannur again. Then we have Koleli Gram Panchayat from Thrissur, Gramavaram Gram Panchayat from Kottayam, Katakada Gram Panchayat from Thiruvananthapuram, Kottakkal Municipality in Malappuram District, and we have the Thrissur District Panchayat. So their representatives, the presidents, the chairpersons will present their experiences. And as panelists, we have Mrs. Shobha Koshi, who was the former chairperson of the Kerala State Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Then we have Sri G. Balgopal, IAS retired, who was also the country head or country representatives of UNICEF in various countries. And we have Dr. Kathireshan from the National Institute of Rural Development and Panchayati Raj, Hyderabad. And of course, as in the past, we have Dr. Thomas Isaac, the Honorable Minister for Finance, with us. And welcome all of them to this webinar. Of course, this is an event jointly organized by Gulati Institute of Finance for Finance and Taxation, the GIFT. Its director, Dr. K.J. Joseph, is here, as well as we partner with Harita Kerala Mission. The Honorable Executive Vice Chairperson, Dr. T.N. Seema, is also there with us. Welcome, all of them. And of course, we have this large gathering of participants who are actually watching it from various places in the country and abroad through the Facebook pages or through the YouTube pages or through the Zoom. Welcome all of them. So with these words, I welcome our Honorable Minister for Health, Social Justice and Women and Child Development, Srimati Teacher, to inaugurate this webinar. Teacher, over to.
Okay. Respected dignitaries who are participating in this very novel webinar on child rights, my dear brothers and sisters, it is the responsibility of the society to protect the child rights and save our children. And we are implementing these things through several governing bodies, through the departments and also by the local self-government. I deal with the health department and also the women and children department and social justice also. All these departments are dealing with the rights of child, and we are implementing this thing through local self-governments. We can say all the institutions are transferred to local self-government after the 73rd and 73rd amendments of our constitution. And local self-governments have a leading role to protect the rights of the child. We can say that the child rights are a subset of human rights. And we give special intervention to provide or to get protection and care to the child. Some special intervention should be there in local self-governments and also in departments. We are defining the child rights according to the Convention of UN, CRC. And after that, the child rights is defined. What and what are the child rights? Child has the rights of the grown-up people or the citizen. Rights to everything. Right to speech and right to express their idea or thought and rights to be free from fear. And also to make participation, etc. CRC classifies these rights into three P's. One is provision and other is protection. And the third one is participation. We should have to ensure the child should have to allow to enjoy all these three P's. Provision means the right to adequate standard of living from birth to how they are brought up and how we are attending the needs of the child from the time of the birth itself. They should have to have a place to born safely. That is the first thing. Allow to enjoy all these three P's. And the second thing is the protection. Protection from abuse and protection from neglect and protection from exploitation and discrimination. And also the third one, participation, means the child is like their grown-up being and like all citizens. There should be a chance to participate in the society, to act, to decide, and to participate in every function of the society. The child has the right. And we should examine whether it is happening or not. After independence, I afraid that most of the children are not enjoying their rights in India. Our constitution specifies child rights also, and we are signatory of the CRC also. But most of the children in India cannot enjoy this freedom or enjoy these rights, which we are decided to have. What is the fate of the children here? A large number of children have no place to born safely, to get nutritious food, to go to school, education. They are working. We have several laws to protect the child, several acts in our Indian parliament. We have passed the legislations. And we have the Juvenile Justice Act. Recently we have the new POCSO Act. We have the Child Labor Prevention Act. So many acts are there. But what is the fate of the child in India? Most of them are working. They are not going to school. Even though they are entered school, the dropout is a large number of dropouts are there. But Kerala has a different atmosphere here. From 1957 onwards, we have some social reforms. Because of that social reforms, we are in the forefront in some of the social indices. We can see that in the health sector, in the other social sector, etc. Some indices, we are in the forefront. Dropout in Kerala is very, very less. Even in the tribal sector, we are doing a good job in the leadership of local self-government. We are sending our children to school and we are ensuring that they are getting proper education. There may be some loopholes, but the other parts, I think it is not the same situation in other parts of the country. In other states, some states, children are not going to school. They are going to work in a hazardous job, we can say. and no protection for these tribes. We should have to ensure their rights. In Kerala, we are trying our best. Department is doing some job. My department is dealing with the Integrated Child Development Scheme. That is central scheme, you know, ICDS. And more than 70,000 people are working there. Officers are there. Anganwadi workers and helpers are there. ICDS supervisors are there. And CDPOs are there. And their responsibility is to look after the children below 5 years. Prenatal, antenatal, postnatal, and from birth itself. That is the first right, to allow them to born in a safe place. We are examining. In Kerala now, institutional delivery is increased because of this work of Anganwadi workers and helpers and also ASHA workers. And in Panchayat, Kudumbasri is there. Bala Sabha is there. So many organizations are there under the department and under the local self-government. And we are watching them thoroughly. And the nutrition. Now the central government declared the National Nutrition Mission. And under that mission, Kerala also declared that mission with our own specifications. Here, Sambushta Kerala. It is in par with the National Nutrition Mission. And we are trying to best to provide our children nutritious foods. We are making it nutritious by adding the nutrients. And through the Anganwadi, we are ensuring that the little one are getting proper food, nutritious food. And that have a very good impact in the society. Because of the reforms over the year, we are doing so many things. The fate of children in Kerala is different from other part, I can say so. Maybe something better than us in some states and throughout the country, we can adopt that. But a society as a whole, if we are talking the society as a whole, we have several achievements. We can definitely say so. But in health sector, we are doing more things that we are trying to reduce the child mortality rate and maternal mortality rate. We announced, this government announced some sustainable development goals after the announcement of SDG of the several achievements. We can definitely say so. And the most important thing is more things. So decrease the maternal mortality rate and child mortality rate. We yield a very good result within these 4 years. From 1957 onwards, we are trying and our indices are better comparing to other state before also. But throughout these 4 years, we have special intention according to the SDG of United Nations. We also declared some SDG here and we organized some expert group to achieve that result. One team was working with the reduction of maternal mortality. And in 2016, our maternal mortality rate was 67 out of 1 lakh live birth, 1 lakh delivery. But now that decreased to, last year it became 46. And we got first place in India. We got an award from our union government. Because that is the lowest rate of maternal mortality in India, and we achieved the first place. And today, that become 43. From 46, it become 43, and we gained some more result. And in the case of child mortality rate, infant mortality rate, IMR, it was 12 out of 1,000 live birth in 2016. But it decreased to single digit and becomes 7. It's a very great achievement, we can say so. How we achieved this result? It is the very good job, very good work that organized by local self-governments in each and every place. The Anganwadi workers and helpers are working with them. The accredited social health activists, ASHA workers, are working with the local self government. And they have so many projects for child health and maternal health. And with the we are working with unity, collective work. The result of the collective work, we achieved a very good result in IMR also. And we should have to make it sure that the acts are implementing for the poor children. JJ Act, Juvenile Justice Act, defines several things. We should make it sure in each and every panchayat, we should have some project to ensure the rights which is in these laws. And we are trying to do so, but we have to move forward. We have to walk miles to go in this aspect. We have to ensure that we are saying that the protection from abuse, but one thing we should have in our mind, that the child abuse is rampant in Kerala also. Even though we got several plus points or first places, several developments, but the child abuse, we cannot say that it is over and no child was abused in Kerala, and child abuse is there. In the family, they are suffering, the children are suffering. Most of the cases, when we examine the abuse or the neglect or the exploitation, everything is inside the family. Most of it is inside the family. Then our local self-government have more responsibility to make it sure that the family is a comfortable place for the child. In our department, this Women and Children department, we started a program called Responsible Parentship. What is the responsible parentship? That means to ensure the rights of child, right, freedom to speak, and also to participate in the activity. That should be ensured in the family itself. From the family, we should have start from the family itself. And to ensure protection in the family. We want to send a child or to nurture or raise a child in the family first. Institutional care is the last thing. In my department also, there are so many children who have no aspects or provision in the family. We are taking the institutional care as a last destination. We like to send the children to home. So Social Justice, Women and Children Department is sending the children either home and ensure the care, or the institutions. And in the institutions also, we should have to provide the care and love what they are getting from the home. And we are sending children to foster care, the poor children who become destitutes. We are sending the children to foster care and ensuring the family affection and care there. We should have to expand that kind of things more. There are so many children in the family who are suffering the neglect and exploitation there. And also, there are so many laws, Child Labor Act, it is there. But the children, how the children are happening to go to the labor, we should examine that. In Kerala, we have a very good project called Sharana Balyam. And through that project, we are examining whether any children are working paid labor or other kind of labor in any place. We are examining, our scores are there in each and every district. Six people who are trained, a resource group is there. They are examining thoroughly and they are watching. And if any child labor come under their attention, they are adults, they are intervening in it and saving that child. It just started in the Shabarimala in the that season. And so many children from outside the states are coming there to sell something or for some kind of labor. Someone are bringing children from other states. And we are rescuing them. We rescued more than 150 children through Charanabalyam. Most of them are from other states outside Kerala. A few children are from Kerala, all the others are from outside, and we are sending the children to their parents, inquiring about their parents and ensuring the safety there. We are sending them to their own home. Otherwise, if they have no home to return, we are admitting them to our homes, and we are sending them to schools, and we are protecting them like that. And this child marriage, all the local self-government should be very keen on this issue. I thought, first of all, that there are no child marriage in Kerala before 5 or 10 years. But when I was a worker of All India Democratic Women's Association, we studied about this. We have a very good survey on that. Seema is here. Seema and I are working, as the state office bearers of AIDWA. At that time, we had a very good survey, and we find out that child marriage is here also in Kerala, in some districts. But it is not rampant. In some district or some place, it is happening here. And we should get rid of that also. Local self-government should attend that that thing also, and have a very good project on that. And in health sector, 100% immunization. Our society is educated, and Kerala have total literacy, 100% literacy. And we thought that every people is ready to have immunization. But in some part, that also fine. I think it is not a common thing. In some part, people are not like to have the vaccination, etc. And we fight hard against that. With the help of the local self-government and leaders, we ensure at that place that total immunization is getting to the child. We are doing that also. And we should focus on this kind of issues. I am not I am not elaborating my speech because the experts are sitting there. So many dignitaries who are working in child rights sector is there, and leaders of local self-government is there. And I think after your discussion, more points will come out, and we will get some platform to act more effectively. And we are trying our best in health sector and this women and child sector. So many projects are there. I am not mentioning everything to help the child. For adolescents also, there are so many projects. The adolescent issue is a severe issue. At that stage, they are not getting attention, or they cannot share their feelings and emotion to others. And they are getting suicide, and they are doing some that kind of thing. And we should protect that adults and children also. This is the season of pandemic. The pandemic is jeopardizing all the rights of human beings. Not only grown-up people, but also children are also becoming more vulnerable, or they are attacking the rights of children also, this pandemic. And they are in the home for more time with the elders, and they cannot be good term with sometimes children are suffering with the torturing and the other kind of abuse, etc. I think our Honorable Chief Minister, in his press meet last day, he told us that more than 60 children committed suicide during this pandemic season. That is a severe thing. We should open our eyes and look at the social problem more strongly. And I have hope that if we work collectively, we can get rid of this kind of problems also. And my department will do as much as we can. And with the help of local self-government, I am thinking that we can do more scientifically to tackle this problem. And the children are our wealth, and they have equal freedom and equal right of every citizen. Any citizen, it is equal to, children are equal to any grown-up human being, and we can ensure, we should ensure their rights in, defined in CRC and defined by ourselves, what is the children's right, and we should protect all the rights of children. Once again, I want to convey my thanks to invite me to this kind of a very good webinar, and thanks to all. With these words, I'm concluding my speech. Thank you all.
Thank you very much, teacher. You have always been our source of inspiration, motivation, and support. Thank you once again. Now we move on to the next session, where Dr. Peter M. Raj, the Associate Professor of KILA, will moderate the especially the session on the presentations by the local governments. Over to Dr. Peter Raj.
Microphone and mute.
Dr. Peter, please unmute your.
Clear now?
Yes.
Okay, sorry for that. So, honorable ministers, other dignitaries, and the local governments who are going to make their presentations today. As already been informed, we have 7 local governments making their presentations today. Out of them, 5 are Grama Panchayats, one is municipality, another one is District Panchayat Thrissur or DPC Thrissur. And we have, out of the 7, we have local governments from North Kerala, that is Kannur, and local governments from South Kerala, that is Trivandrum. So that means that child friendly, when you listen to them, may vary from one locality to locality. That is why the significance of child friendly local governments coming into significance. So here we are sure that when you listen to or hear the presentations, rather the experience sharing of all these 7 local governments, you will understand what exactly is child-friendly local governance means. Maybe some of them will have common programs and activities which may you may see from the same in all these panchayats, all these local governments, but everybody will have some specificities. So that is what make them unique in their own way. So with that very brief introduction, I'm happy to invite the 7 local governments one by one. First, we go to Valapattanam Grama Panchayats, situated in the district Kannur, North Kerala. Here, as you will see their presentation, their focus is carrying out with the child rights realization through children's library owned by the Grama Panchayats. So it means that a library, how it becomes a duty bearer in realizing the rights of the children. So I warmly welcome the president and other members of the Grama Panchayat to make their presentation. Madam Lalita Devi BK, president of Valapattanam Grama Panchayat, hearty welcome for your presentation.
Valapattanam Grama Panchayat, child friendly local governance എന്ന വിഷയത്തെ ആസ്പദമാക്കി കില നടത്തുന്ന ഈ വെബിനാറിൽ ഏറെ അഭിമാനത്തോടെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തിനെ അവതരിപ്പിക്കുന്നു. വളവട്ടണം ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തിൻ്റെ ലൈബ്രറി ഡേ ചിൽഡ്രൻസ് ഫോറം തീർത്ത വിസ്മയകരമായ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളിൽ ഊന്നലകിക്കൊണ്ടുള്ളതാണ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രവർത്തനം. കോവിഡ് കാലഘട്ടത്തിൽ ഞങ്ങളുടെ പഞ്ചായത്തും ലൈബ്രറിയും കുട്ടിയോടെ നിർമ്മിച്ച അതിജീവനത്തിന്റെ ഒരു മാതൃക അത്രമേൽ അഭിമാനകരമാണ്.
വളപട്ടണം ഇസ് എ പ്ലേസ് റിച്ച് വിത്ത് ഇറ്റ്സ് ബയോഡൈവേഴ്സിറ്റി, കൾച്ചർ ആൻഡ് ഹിസ്റ്റോറിക്കൽ ബാക്ക്ഗ്രൗണ്ട്. ഔട്ട് ഓഫ് ദ ടോട്ടൽ പോപ്പുലേഷൻ ഓഫ് 7,955, 2,810 of them are children. Let us categorize the children according to their age. Let us see the major developmental issues of children. Gaps in immunization coverage, single parenting due to migration to Gulf countries, drug abuse, dropout of girl children from higher education pursuits, lack of facilities for children of migrant laborers, and lack of proper study facilities for children in some joint families. We have been conducting special Grama Sabha of children since 2017, and the major suggestions from the Grama Sabha are: give child rights awareness to parents, programs for children in holidays for creative development, ensure good facilities in schools, ensure parks, playgrounds, cycle paths, ensure exercise facility for girls, conduct drug awareness programs, start higher education guidance center, gender training to boys, reduce the weight of school bags, and road safety. We are keen to make a change in the living conditions through more social involvement of children through creative programs. There are a lot of changes happening among the children in the Valapattanam Grama Panchayat. The modern construction of Valapattanam Higher Secondary School building has been completed with the use of KIFBI fund. There is a park and open library near the Valapattanam riverside. Family Health Center of Valapattanam has all modern facilities, including child-friendly immunization hall. Football coaching classes are also conducted by a club in the playground of Valapattanam Grama Panchayat. We are also able to maintain the immunization coverage rate as 73% with the intervention of health workers and Grama Panchayat authorities. We are conducting various awareness programs to bridge the gap and fulfill the aim of achieving 100% immunization. One of the major recommendations that arose from the Children's Grama Sabha was to provide proper guidance for proper parenting. It was utmost important that every home be aware of the problems faced by children. There is a need for parents to know about their children's health, development, partnership and protection. Thus, the Grama Panchayat library became the hub of learning. On the basis of this recommendation, Valapattanam Grama Panchayat library started parenting school in 2017. We already conducted 8 training programs and awareness classes during the year 2017-19. Our children's forum presented a study about the approaches and attitude of parents towards their children. After these sessions, a very visible change could be seen among the parents. The Valapattanam Grama Panchayat Library Children's Forum is an institutional model for children. More than 500 children are a part of it. We conduct more than 50 programs annually for children. Creative Homes Defeat COVID is a special intervention through library to help children overcome the COVID lockdown. We also conduct summer camps, which has school-based programs and play activities. We have a park and a park library. A special program for the 7th class students through library is named as Unarva Race. Campaign against drug abuse is also a main area of focus. The Grama Panchayat Library conducted a program in the name of My India, Yours Too, participating the children of migrant laborers from other states.
Maria, Secretary of Children's Forum. Every year, Valapattanam Library conducts minimum 15 programs combined with Valapattanam schools. School literary platforms like Vidyananga clubs are also conducting programs combined with library. Library visiting and library's orientation classes are also conducted as a part of this. Children's cooperation between each other helps to develop their reading habits. Of the inauguration of Reading Month celebration is taking part in library, the closing ceremony will be in Government Valapattanam High Secondary Schools.
ഞാൻ ആദിത്യ ടി ഇ ലൈബ്രറിയുടെ ചിൽഡ്രൻസ് ഫോറത്തിന്റെ വൈസ് പ്രസിഡന്റ് ആണ്. ഈ കഴിഞ്ഞ എസ് എൽ സി പരീക്ഷ എല്ലാ വിഷയത്തിലും മുഴുവൻ എ പ്ലസ് എനിക്ക് കിട്ടിയിട്ടുണ്ട്. ചിൽഡ്രൻസ് ഫോറം പരിപാടികളുടെ കോർഡിനേഷൻ ഞാൻ വളരെ ആസ്വദിച്ച് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. അത് എന്റെ വിജയത്തിനേറെ സഹായിച്ചിട്ടുമുണ്ട്.
We conducted summer vacation camps for children every year. The programs are coordinated and executed by children.
ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് ലൈബ്രറി 3500-ലധികം പുസ്തകങ്ങളാണ് കുട്ടികളുടെ വിഭാഗത്തിൽ മാത്രമായുള്ളത്. എല്ലാ വർഷവും ഞങ്ങൾ കുട്ടികൾ ലൈബ്രറിയുടെ നേതൃത്വത്തിൽ ഒരു പുസ്തകോത്സവ യാത്ര നടത്താറുണ്ട്. 2016 ആരംഭിച്ച ഈ ഒരു സംരംഭ പ്രവർത്തനം ഇന്ന് കണ്ണൂർ ജില്ലയിൽ 20-ലധികം ലൈബ്രറികൾ ഏറ്റെടുത്ത് നടത്തുന്നു. അങ്ങനെ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ആവശ്യമുള്ള പുസ്തകങ്ങൾ ഞങ്ങൾ തന്നെ തിരഞ്ഞെടുത്ത് വായിക്കുന്നു.
An innovative project of the Valapattanam Grama Panchayat Library in the year 2019-20 was named as Unarv, Children's Library Comprehensive Activities. The aim of the project was to lead children to comprehensive personality development. The targeted group was the 7th standard students of the Valapattanam Grama Panchayat. As a part of this initiative, workshops were conducted, diaries for book appreciation and observations were also distributed.
2018 നമ്മുടെ ലൈബ്രറി ചിൽഡ്രൻസ് പാർക്കിൽ ഒരു ഓപ്പൺ ലൈബ്രറി ആരംഭിച്ചു. 2018 തന്നെ നമ്മൾ കുട്ടികളുടെ ഒരു കമ്മിറ്റി രൂപീകരിച്ചു. ആ കമ്മിറ്റിയിൽ ചില കുട്ടി ലൈബ്രറിമാരുണ്ടായിരുന്നു.
കോവിഡ് ലോക്ക്ഡൌൺ വിറ്റ്നസ്ഡ് ഐസൊലേഷൻ ഓഫ് ചിൽഡ്രൻ. ദ യൂഷ്വൽ ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ് ഓഫ് ലൈബ്രറി കെയിം ടു എ സ്റ്റാൻഡ് സ്റ്റിൽ. ടു ഹെൽപ് ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഓവർകം ദിസ് ഐസൊലേഷൻ ആൻഡ് ബ്രിങ് ഔട്ട് ദിയർ ക്രിയേറ്റീവ് പൊട്ടൻഷ്യൽസ് We started a virtual platform named Creative Homes Defeat COVID. It was started on March 22nd, a day before the lockdown started in India. Around 200 children were members of this virtual platform. They are grouped into 7 teams with a mentor and a leader. Leadership models in new normal life, production of masks, sanitizers, surveys, studies, Contributions to CMDRF were some of the activities carried out by the children. Online study facilities through Children's Initiative is also to be noted as an important activity. We consider this as a model of children's unity for survival. Creative activities, publications, videos, cultural fest, and more than 6,000 creations have come up through this group.
കോവിഡ് കാലത്ത് വീട്ടിലൊട്ടുപെട്ടു പോകുന്ന അവസ്ഥയെ മറികടക്കാനും സ്കൂളിലെ പതിവ് കൂട്ടുകാർക്ക് പുറമെ പുതു സൗഹൃദം ഉണ്ടാക്കുവാനും ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കഴിഞ്ഞു. ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഈ ദിവസങ്ങൾ പോയത് തന്നെ അറിഞ്ഞില്ല.
ഐ എം മുഹമ്മദ് നേഹാൻ, എ മെമ്പർ ഓഫ് ചിൽഡ്രൻസ് ഫോറം കമ്മിറ്റി. വി നോ ദാറ്റ് മാസ്ക് ഇസ് എസൻഷ്യൽ ഡ്യൂറിംഗ് ദിസ് പാൻഡമിക് പീരിയഡ്. ബിഫോർ ദി ഗവൺമെന്റ് സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് എൻ അവയർനെസ് പ്രോഗ്രാം, വി ഹാഡ് ഡെവലപ്ഡ് എൻ അവയർനെസ് വീഡിയോ റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദിസ്.
ഹലോ, ഈ കൊറോണ വൈറസിനെ പ്രതിരോധിക്കാനുള്ള നമുക്കറിയുന്ന മാർഗം നമ്മുടെ കൂട്ടുകാരോട് പങ്കുവെച്ചാലോ? തീർച്ചയായും. കൈകൾ ഇടയ്ക്കിടെ സോപ്പോ ഹാൻഡ് വാഷോ ഉപയോഗിച്ച് നന്നായി കഴുകുക. പിന്നെ അതിനുശേഷം സാനിറ്റൈസർ ഉപയോഗിച്ച് അകം വശോ പുറം വശോ നന്നായി റബ് ചെയ്യുക. തരുമ്പോൾ നിർബന്ധമായും മാസ്ക് ധരിക്കുക.
Children of our Creative Homes has developed e-learning resources for the different classes. We also prepared 7 memory books based on the memories shared by the grandparents. 500 saplings were planted by our group members on the occasion of World Environment Day.
I am Aman, member of Children Forum Committee. We wanted to do something to raise money for helping people during this pandemic. So we decided to make these bookmarks. We sold these bookmarks in our neighborhood and were able to collect 50,000. which we were able to contribute towards Chief Minister's Fund.
Creative Home Platform observed different national and international days like World Anti-Drug Day, Reading Day, World Music Day, Biodiversity Day, etc. Reading Month was inaugurated through online platform by the eminent writer Benjamin and concluded with the inspirational talk by Master Harun Karim, a visually impaired student who secured great achievement in the SSLC exam without the support of a scribe.
All these activities gave us to positive energy to overcome the pandemic situation of COVID-19.
Activities of Creative Homes Defeat COVID were featured in the COVID Time Global Report of IFLA, International Federation of Library Association and Institutions. We were one among the 4 libraries featured in their global report. With the rich experience and confidence we gained through these activities, we have decided to go ahead and function like a child-friendly governance at its best. The Valapattanam Grama Panchayat and the library are all set to flourish.
We are not the leaders of tomorrow. We are the leaders of today. We will make a difference in the world.
Well said, Valapattanam, President and the team. Children are not the citizens of tomorrow. They are today's citizens as well as today's leaders. We appreciate your all good efforts. Thank you very much, Madam President and other members. Now, let us move on to Peravur Grama Panchayat. Again, Grama Panchayat in North Kerala of Kannur district. Their child-friendly activities are largely multidimensional. If you say the focus could be more on sports and agriculture, it's like children's involvement in developmental activities. So children becoming developmental agencies. So proud to say that they also received the best child-friendly Grama Panchayat award from the Ministry of Panchayat Raj in 2019 and 20. Madam President, Digi Joy and the team will make their presentation. Welcome.
Ellavarkkum namaskaram. Njan Digi Joy, Kannur jillayile Peravur Panchayath President aanu. 34.10 chadrasara kilometer vistheernamulla Peravur Panchayathile 2011 census prakaram 23704 janangalaanu adivasikkunnathu. Idil 18 vayassil thaazheyulla 5540 kuttikal nilavilundu. ബാല സൗഹൃദ പഞ്ചായത്തായിട്ടാണ് പേരാവൂർ പഞ്ചായത്ത് നിലകൊള്ളുന്നത്. വോളിബോൾ ഇതിഹാസ താരം ജിമ്മി ജോർജിന്റെ നാടായതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ സ്പോർട്സ് മേഖലയെ ഫോക്കസ് ചെയ്തുകൊണ്ടുള്ള പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളാണ് പഞ്ചായത്ത് പദ്ധതി വെച്ച് നടത്തിക്കൊണ്ടു പോരുന്നത്.
പേരാവൂർ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് ഹാസ് 16 വാർഡ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഇറ്റ് കവേർഡ് നിയർലി 35 കിലോമീറ്റേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് ഏരിയ. ദേർ ആർ 5540 ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഇൻ ദ ജൂറിസ്ഡിക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ പഞ്ചായത്ത്. The major focus of child-friendly panchayat include the child immunization, school dropout, child abuses, drug abuse, children's gram sabha and agriculture. The major issues include the lacking interest of sports activities, mobile phone addiction, absenteeism of the tribal children, lacking the physical strength of the children and the nutritional issues of the children. The child-friendly programs mainly include the children's Grama Sabha, sports and games coaching, standardized playground, organic farming in the school, various scholarship programs for the disabled children, activities to promote physical fitness of children, and several tribal projects to reduce the absenteeism. As part of this, 24 Anganwadis were changed to child-friendly Anganwadis. Several coachings include the yoga and the martial art were also started. As a result of all these activities, we won the national award for the best child friendly panchayat in the year of 2020.
Kilayil vechulla training session njangal aadyamayi cheythathu panchayathil 16 wardilum kuttikalude grama sabha cheyyuka ennalladayirunnu. Aa grama sabhayil ninnum kuttikalude nethrithathil oru paadu vishayangal uruthirinju varunnathu njangalkku kaanuvan vendi saadichu. ആധുനിക സാങ്കേതിക വിദ്യയുടെ സഹായത്തോടു കൂടിയുള്ള പരിശീലനങ്ങളുടെ അഭാവം ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കാണുവാൻ വേണ്ടി സാധിച്ചു. അതോടൊപ്പം കുട്ടികൾ മൊബൈൽ പോലുള്ള വിവര സാങ്കേതിക വിദ്യയിലേക്ക് മാറുന്നതായി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് മാറുവാൻ വേണ്ടി സാധിച്ചു. കുട്ടികൾ പറയുകയാണ്, ഞങ്ങൾ സ്കൂളുകളിൽ പച്ചക്കറി കൃഷി നടത്തുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് അവസരമുണ്ടാക്കി തരണം. അങ്ങനെ കാർഷിക മേഖലയിലേക്ക് ആ കുട്ടികളെ തിരിച്ചു കൊണ്ടുവരുവാനും അവിടെ കൃഷി ചെയ്ത ഫലം ഉപയോഗിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഉച്ചഭക്ഷണത്തിൽ ചോറിന് കറിയായി കൊടുക്കുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടിയുള്ള അവസരമുണ്ടാക്കണമെന്ന് കുട്ടികൾ പറയുകയാണ്. ഞങ്ങളുടെ അംഗൻവാടികൾക്ക് മികച്ച രീതിയിൽ ബിൽഡിങ്ങുകൾ ഉണ്ടാക്കണമെന്ന നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങൾ വരികയാണ്. ഇത്തരത്തിൽ നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങൾ വന്നതിന്റെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിലാണ് ഞങ്ങൾ വീണ്ടും കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി പ്രൊജക്ടുകൾ തയ്യാറാക്കുവാൻ വേണ്ടി തീരുമാനിച്ചത്.
The hospital child friendly ward. The children's ward at the Taluk hospital has been converted into a child friendly ward with baby friendly painting, playground and all other facilities. This facility was set up free of cost by the family and friends of Dr. Deepak, who is the victim of Nepal earthquake. Pediatric vaccination is 100% completed. pregnant women are able to receive monthly checkups and complete the vaccination in a timely manner from the time of their birth to 15 years of age. BPL cards are getting maternity benefits, and also the children below the age of 18 are being provided the medical facilities, include the medicines from outside the medical store. As part of the project Drug Free Panchayat, a proclamation rally was organized in the town under the auspices of the Peravur Panchayat. Seminar and quiz competitions were also organized as part of this in the schools for the children. Under the auspices of Peravur Panchayat, organic vegetable cultivations were started in all the schools under the Panchayat. The vegetables required for lunch were started in the respective schools. Water Bell Program. This enabled the children of Peravur Panchayat in their schools to alleviate their fatigue, alleviate their ailments, and help the children to stay in class with enthusiasm. Each child brings boiled water from home on their own steel bottles and makes sure that all the children drink bottled water by the time. The bell rings 4 times a day and they have finished drinking all the water by the evening. Every year, the Panchayat conducts volleyball training for the children. The training is being led by Sebastian Sir, a great volleyball player. We could find a lot of athletes in this area. While coaching these kids, in a way, this will ensure their future is secure. There are also kids who stayed in the academy. Having the best coaches increases the likelihood of this activity. The governing body of the Panchayat has been conducting football training since its inception. The children are being trained from the Kunitala school grounds under the leadership of the Red Star Club by a teacher from the same school. About 125 children are participating in the training, which will be held from 6 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. The Panchayat is providing the facilities they need as part of the project. Many children benefit from this as they strive to increase their mental and physical abilities. The academy was inaugurated by our health minister Shailaja teacher, and many children are mastering this martial art. They are a role model for every child who clings to information technology at home, such as mobile, while helping their children to develop their flexibility and build a healthy body and thereby develop their intelligence. The institution provides all the necessary assistance to these children to cope with these activities through a regular lifestyle. Many children, including boys and girls, acquire all the skills to defend themselves. Then they became its trainers. We were assisted in organizing this project under the leadership of Ramesan Sir, the Fire Force staff of Peravur Panchayat itself. This project was implemented as part of the realization that swimming is necessary and inevitable for the children. Physical fitness training. The boys' training will be held free of cost at the Jimmy George Stadium from 6:30 a.m. to 8:30 a.m. About 200 children have been trained. The project called Thudikottu is introduced for the prevention of dropouts in the tribal settings of Peravur Panchayat. The teachers were allotted for the whole tribal colonies and they have the duty to teach the tribal students from 7 a.m. to 9 a.m. They are also giving the special assistance to the children who are marginalized in the society. They are also assure the whole process of schooling, including the transportation and the food facilities. Through this project, we could reduce the school dropout of the tribal children.
ഇങ്ങനെ കുട്ടികളെ ചേർത്ത് നിർത്തി പരിശീലനം നൽകിയതിന്റെ ഭാഗമായിട്ട് ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രവർത്തനത്തിന്റെ എല്ലാം മികവിന്റെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിൽ മധ്യപ്രദേശിൽ ഗ്വാളിയറിൽ വെച്ച് ബാലസൗഹൃദ ദേശീയ ശില്പശാല നടന്നപ്പോൾ ആ ശില്പശാലയിൽ കേരളത്തെ പ്രതിനിധീകരിച്ച് രണ്ടാളുകൾ പങ്കെടുത്തപ്പോൾ അതിൽ ഒരാളായി പേരാവൂർ പഞ്ചായത്ത് നടപ്പിലാക്കിയ പ്രൊജക്ടുകൾ രാജ്യത്തിന് തന്നെ മാതൃകയാവുന്ന രീതിയിൽ അവതരിപ്പിക്കുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് സാധിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി. അങ്ങനെ ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രവർത്തനം നടത്തുമ്പോൾ ആ പ്രവർത്തനത്തിൻ്റെ മികവ് കണ്ടെത്തിയതുകൊണ്ടാകാം 2020 മികച്ച ബാലസൗഹൃദ പഞ്ചായത്ത് എന്ന അവാർഡും പേരാവൂർ പഞ്ചായത്തിനെ തന്നെ തേടിയെത്തുകയുണ്ടായി. ഈ കോവിഡ് കാലത്തും പേരാവൂർ പഞ്ചായത്തിലെ കുട്ടികൾ വിശ്രമമില്ലാതെ തിരക്കിലായിരുന്നു. അവർക്ക് ഓൺലൈൻ സർഗോത്സവത്തിലൂടെ വിവിധ തരത്തിലുള്ള പരിപാടികൾ നടത്തിക്കൊണ്ട് 18 വയസ്സിൽ താഴെയുള്ള മുഴുവൻ കുട്ടികളെയും അതിൽ പങ്കാളികളായിട്ടുള്ള പ്രവർത്തനം നടത്തിയപ്പോൾ ഞങ്ങൾ പെരാമ പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഭരണസമിതിയും ചാരിതാർത്ഥിയാണ് ഇക്കാര്യത്തിൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഇതിന് അവസരം നൽകിയത്. കിലയിൽ വെച്ച് ട്രെയിനിങ് നൽകിയപ്പോൾ പദ്ധതിയുടെ 5% തുകയും കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി ചെലവഴിക്കണമെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ അത് അക്ഷരാർത്ഥത്തിൽ നടപ്പിലാക്കി കൊണ്ടുപോകുവാൻ വേണ്ടി ഞങ്ങളെ സഹായിച്ചത് കിലയിൽ നിന്നും ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് കിട്ടിയ ട്രെയിനിങ് ആണ്. ഈ ട്രെയിനിങ്ങിൽ ഞങ്ങളെ സഹായിച്ച ഞങ്ങളുടെ മെന്റർ ആർ പി ശാന്തമ്മ ടീച്ചർ, കില ഡയറക്ടർ, കിലയിലെ മറ്റ് ഭാരവാഹികൾ മുഴുവൻ ആളുകൾക്കും ഞങ്ങളുടെ നന്ദിയും കടപ്പാടും അറിയിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് നിർത്തുന്നു. നിങ്ങൾക്ക് ഏവർക്കും എന്റെ അഭിവാദനങ്ങൾ.
Thank you, Peravur, for your unique interventions. Now we move on to Kolazhi Gram Panchayat in Thrissur district. Kolazhi, the speciality of this particular panchayat is they have been arranging lot of public space for children, and children thereby are getting the capacity to become decision makers. This panchayat also got the best child friendly gram panchayat award from the Ministry of Panchayat Raj during the year 2018 and 2019. Welcome Sri PG Unnikrishnan, the president of the gram panchayat, and Srimathi Jessi Lonappan, the vice president of the gram panchayat, for your presentation.
Ellavarkkum namaskaram. Njan PG Unnikrishnan, Kolazhi gram panchayat president. 2017 18 ബാലസൗഹൃദ തദ്ദേശ ഭരണത്തിനുള്ള പ്രഥമ ദേശീയ പുരസ്കാരം കോലേ ഗ്രാമ പഞ്ചായത്തിന് ലഭിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി.
ഡീറ്റെയിൽസ് ഓഫ് വേരിയസ് ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ് ഫ്രം 2016. ഇൻസ്റ്റെഡ് ഓഫ് 5% ഓഫ് ദ ഡെവലപ്മെന്റ് ഫണ്ട്, അബൌട്ട് 40% ഓഫ് ദ ഫണ്ട് ഈസ് ഇയർ മാർക്ക്ഡ്. ഫോർ എക്സാമ്പിൾ, റുപ്പീസ് 72,29,830 ഡ്യൂറിംഗ് 2018-19.
ഞാൻ ജെസ്സി ലോനപ്പൻ, കോലടി ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തിൻ്റെ വൈസ് പ്രസിഡൻ്റ്. സി എഫ് എൽ ജിയുടെ 2016 മുതലുള്ള പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളാണ് ഇവിടെ പറയാൻ പോകുന്നത്. ചൈൽഡ് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി കോലടി ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് കതിർമണികൾ. ചൈൽഡ് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി കോലടി. Child population. Child friendly Kolazhi Gram Panchayat significance. Major suggestions from Children's Gram Sabha. Child friendly programs and activities. Child-friendly programs and activities. Achievements. ബെസ്റ്റ് ചൈൽഡ് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് അവാർഡ്, സിവിൽ സർവീസ് ട്രെയിനിങ്, ബാലമേള ആൻഡ് ബാലസഭ ടൂർ, ദ ഗ്രീൻ സ്കൂൾ, സ്റ്റുഡൻസ് പോലീസ് കാരറ്റ്, സ്റ്റേറ്റ് ലെവൽ അവാർഡ് സെറമണി,
മാക്സ് ലാബ് ആൻഡ് സ്മാർട്ട് ക്ലാസ് റൂം ഇൻ ഗവൺമെന്റ് എൽ പി സ്കൂൾ കുറ്റു, 12 സ്മാർട്ട് ക്ലാസ് റൂം ഇൻ ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഹയർ സെക്കൻഡറി സ്കൂൾ, സോ ഓൾസോ സ്റ്റാർ പ്ലാന്റ്സ്, ബട്ടർഫ്ലൈ ഗാർഡൻ and herbal garden.
Members of UNICEF, State Child Right Commission, Administrative Reforms Committee Extra, Visitor Colliery Panchayat, Feeding Room attached to Front Office, Modernized Anganwadis, Morning Meal in UP School, Enhanced Presence of Students and Standard of Learning. Various programs to sustain CFLG, Empowerment of Jagrata Samiti, expansion of existing 49 Balasabhas, which include about 1,050 children. Students have been provided with television and smartphones, facilitations for agricultural and poultry activities, scholarship for artistic performance of students, sex ratio of 0-6 children, 1,004 is an achievement. Service of students of BSW, MSW and NSS from St. Mary's College, Thrissur is ensured. Continuous vigilance of police and excise departments. Awareness programs against substance use. Plans for 100% registration of birth and vaccination. Special drive to reduce dropout rate of students, various subcommittees and monitoring committee for evaluation and appropriate action. Gram Sabha of Children is active and effective.
ഇതുവരെ കോലൈ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തിനോട് സഹകരിച്ച എല്ലാവർക്കും, പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് കിളിക്കും തദ്ദേശ സ്വയംഭരണ വകുപ്പിനും കോലൈ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തിന്റെ നന്ദി അറിയിച്ചുകൊള്ളുന്നു.
President and the team members of the Kolari Gram Panchayat for your very unique initiatives. Now we move on to the presentation by Ramavaram Gram Panchayat in Kottayam district. Amidst several other things, the Gram Panchayat Ramavaram is focusing on evolving child leadership. They'll invest a lot among the children to make them leaders of today. And that's how their involvement is very visible in all the development activities of the Gram Panchayat. In fact, they have a special child focal point in the Gram Panchayat office itself. So we welcome Mr. Baiju John, the president of the Gram Panchayat, and Mr. Jean Sinath, the Health and Education Standing Committee chairperson, for the presentation.
Kila nalgiya bala sahurda aashayangal വാസ്തവത്തിൽ ഞങ്ങൾ ജനപ്രതിനിധികളുടെ വികസന കാഴ്ചപ്പാടുകളെയാണ് മാറ്റിമറിച്ചത്. വികസനം എന്നാൽ കേവലം റോഡ്, തോട്, പാലങ്ങൾ മുതലായവയ്ക്ക് ഉപരിയായി മറ്റ് പലതും കൂടിയാണെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ തിരിച്ചറിഞ്ഞു. അതിൽ പ്രധാനം കുട്ടികളുടെ വികസനം തന്നെയാണ്.
This is Ramapuram, the cultural capital of Kottayam district in Kerala. The intervention of society at large in the well-being of its children is a strong indicator of efforts of a civilized society. Children are the asset of the society rather than they belong to their family or religion. All the expenses taken for the well-being of our children are investments to the nation building rather than expenditure. In In 1992, we have signed the Treaty of Child Rights, approved by UNICEF in 1989. As per this treaty, survival, development, security, and participation are the birthright of all the children born here, and ensuring that is the first and foremost responsibility of the government. Let's have a look into the details of initiatives taken in these four vast areas, namely survival, development, security, and participation by Gramapuram Grama Panchayat. Survival. Nutritious food ensured from pregnancy. Preventive vaccinations are ensured. Prevention of malnutrition. Bud school and physiotherapy centers for differently abled children. Ensuring clean drinking water. Ensuring morning meal in primary schools. Development. Improvement of infrastructure in pre-primary schools from Anganwadis. Empowered school reading. Improvement of playgrounds in schools. Ensured equipments for entertainment in schools. Construction of children's parks. Workshops conducted in training in arts and sports. Workshops, seminars, debates and discussions ensured for freedom of expression and free thinking. Security. Ensured children are free from child labor, exploitation and abuses. Ensured security of children from the hands of narcotic drug mafia. Awareness classes and seminars conducted. Special consideration to physically challenged and others who deserve special attention. Ensured no child marriage is happening. Freed children from helplessness and atrocities against them. Participation. Interventions in ward and panchayat level bal sabhas to ensure effective participation of children. Membership of children's representatives are ensured in working groups of different projects. Separate clubs for adolescent girls in Anganwadis. Togetherness of children in Anganwadis in every second Saturday to get involved in creative activities. Ensuring active participation of children in workshops and seminars. The happiness and energy we have obtained in childhood from an unpolluted nature and a secure mind are the roads through which our life journey should progress. Ramapuram Grama Panchayat is taking all the efforts to ensure the taste and beauty of sharing and caring to the new generation. As a first step, get-together of children were arranged in Anganwadis in all the 18 wards of the Panchayat. Panchayat development seminars were conducted ensuring participation of children elected from the get-together. Special working groups are formed to identify and solve the problems and challenges children face. A special officer is appointed in panchayat level only for children to receive complaints and take necessary actions. The most important experience in the efforts of panchayat in making Ramapuram a Bala Sauhrida Panchayat that is children friendly was a 3 days workshop, Sablami Balyam, conducted participating children between the age group of 10 to 18, selected from all the 18 wards of the panchayat. The subjects included organic farming, history of Ramapuram, dangers of not observing traffic rules, green protocol, the necessity of scientific timber, awareness regarding drug abuse, the positives and negatives of social media, healthy living, music appreciation, biodiversity and personality development. The validatory function conducted by the participants themselves on the last day was really overwhelming and spoke about the value addition of the program. The children converted the program as a complete review of the entire 3 days workshop. The performance of the children was substantiating the tagline of the workshop, Saphalami Balyam, let snow and fill, celebrate friendship and bring light. The skits demonstrated by the children on recharging of wells, getting rid of plastic waste, the meaninglessness of the division through caste and religion were loudly applauded. Another memorable event was a symposium, Lessons from Flood and Reconstruction of Kerala. More than 160 children participated in this symposium. The symposium was inaugurated by MG University Vice Chancellor Dr. Sabu Thomas, the Secretary of Shastra Sahitya Parishad. Mr. Joji Kotamal presented a paper on Lessons from Flood and Reconstruction of Kerala. Estimated benefits gained by children. Experienced the sweetness of cooperation and sharing. Fruitful interactions of children with veterans. Substantial improvements in leadership qualities and confidence level. Came to know about hygienic environment, the importance of recharging wells, villain named plastic, eco-friendly agriculture. Children prepared and propagated posters on protection and management of drinking water, disposal of plastic waste, cleaning before the monsoons, and protection of nature. A skit squad was formed to promote the ideas of well recharging, waste disposal, and development of humanity. Abhishek Nambudiri, the coordinator of the Balasabha, was elected president of the Children's Parliament and read the government policy statement in the old assembly hall in recognition to the child-friendly Grama Panchayat workshop of our panchayat. Conclusion. Inspired by the motivation and ideas by Killa in January 2017, the child-friendly activities formed by Ramapuram Grama Panchayat are continuing in an exemplary manner. The mindsets of people's representatives have changed from the illusion that development to the society is not just construction of a road, bridge, or a building. It is the development of children of the society. Many successful projects were designed under the mentorship of Safalam 55 Plus, a consortium of retirees from various fields. Through the child-friendly activities, Ramapuram Panchayat could influence very much the vision and approach to life of new generation. Through our child-friendly activities, Ramapuram Panchayat could influence very much the vision and approach to life of new generation. Now the children are more confident and active because they feel safe as the Panchayat and whole society stand for the welfare and well-being in the key four sectors like survival, development, protection and participation. In addition, environmental protection, waste disposal, avoidance of plastic in a phased manner, upkeep of public places, compassion, rights and duties, awareness about liquor and narcotics are important areas where the presence and intervention are inevitable.
Thank you, Ramapuram Gram Panchayat, the team from Central Kerala. In fact, we offer special thanks to your retirees who work with you voluntarily. Now we move on to Katakada Gram Panchayat in Trivandrum district, the southmost end of Kerala. In fact, they have multi-sectoral interventions and with a more specificity to promotion of child-friendly institutions, including hospitals, the playgrounds, the Anganwadi schools, etc. Welcome, Madam Ajida, the president, and the Panchayat member advocate Sanal Bose for the presentation.
ബാലസഹോദര പഞ്ചായത്തിനെ സംബന്ധിച്ച് പറയുകയാണെങ്കിൽ കിലയിൽ കിട്ടിയ ട്രെയിനിങ്ങിന്റെ അടിസ്ഥാനത്തിൽ സ്കൂളുകളിലും അതുപോലെ കുട്ടികളുടെ വീട്ടിലുള്ള രക്ഷകർത്താക്കളുടെ പ്രവർത്തനത്തിലും ജാഗ്രത സമിതി വളരെ ശക്തമായി നമ്മുടെ പഞ്ചായത്തിൽ കൊണ്ടുവന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. കുട്ടികൾക്ക് ആവശ്യമായ എല്ലാ സൗകര്യങ്ങളും നമ്മൾ ആശുപത്രി തന്നെ എടുത്താൽ തന്നെ അറിയാം. 3 ഹോസ്പിറ്റലാണ് നമുക്കുള്ളത്. സർക്കാരിന്റെ 3 ഹോസ്പിറ്റലിലെ നമ്മൾ ബാലസൗഹൃദ പഞ്ചായത്തിന്റെ ഭാഗമായി കടകംപള്ളി സുരേന്ദ്രൻ സാറ് വന്ന് ഉദ്ഘാടനം നടത്തി ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ബാലസൗഹൃദ പഞ്ചായത്ത് എന്ന പ്രഖ്യാപനവും നേടിയിട്ടുണ്ട് നമ്മുടെ പഞ്ചായത്തിൽ. അതിന്റെ നാമധേയത്തിൽ തന്നെ മരിച്ചുപോയ ലിനിയുടെ നിപ്പ പനി വന്ന് മരിച്ചുപോയ ലിനിയുടെ പേരിൽ നമ്മളൊരു പാർക്ക് സ്ഥാപിക്കുന്നതിന് നമുക്ക് കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്. അംഗൻവാടികൾ ചുവരച്ചിത്രം വരെ ഉൾപ്പെടെയുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങൾ നമുക്ക് ചെയ്യാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുണ്ട്.
കാട്ടാക്കട ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് ഈസ് സിറ്റുവേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ദ ഈസ്റ്റേൺ പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ട്രിവാൻഡ്രം ഡിസ്ട്രിക്ട് ഈസ് ഹാവിംഗ് ഇറ്റ്സ് ഓൺ റിച്ച് കൾച്ചറൽ ഹിസ്റ്ററി. elderly persons. Participation of student police cadet in palliative care, first ever initiative in India by our family health center leadership. By conducting special Grama Sabha of children from different schools on yearly manner since 2017. And constituted Bala Parliament. Grama Sabha for differently abled children on yearly at Panchayat level, the emphasis of administration decentralization was imparted to the children. Since 2017, every year, the Children's Bala Parliament has got unique recommendations to annual projects of our LSGD. Almost all schools has constitutes different types adolescent clubs, namely nature, sports, mechanical, science, etc. The Children's Grama Sabha was convened in all wards, special youth festivals, sports and games event for differently abled children takes place for the last 3 years. The Panchayat, along with all school children, tried our best to prevent and to protect from coronavirus.
എൻ്റെ പേര് ഹന്ന സിൽവസ്റ്റർ. ഞാൻ കാട്ടാക്കട പഞ്ചായത്തിലെ കുട്ടികളുടെ കോർഡിനേറ്ററാണ്.
Thank you very much for your valuable support. In this moment, we would like to thank all persons behind our success. Thank you very much for watching our presentation.
Thank you, Kattakada, for your very good work. Now we move on to Kottakkal Municipality from North Kerala. Kottakkal Municipality is always been promoting the child-centric planning, and the focus area could be child health and education of children. Here with us is respected Municipal Chairperson, Chairman, Mr. K.K. Nasir. Welcome, sir, for your presentation.
Good morning, all. I am K.K. Nasir, Municipal Chairman, Kottakkal. First of all, let me share my thanks to all the organizers who were invited for the webinar on the Child Friendly Kerala.
Hi, I'm Niranjana KK. I'm the leader of Child Friendly Local Governments, Kottakkal Municipality. I'm so glad to inform you that we are conducting very well discussions with the Corporation of Kottakkal Municipality and our public. And we are also participating in the WhatsApps and working groups. And they are giving prior importance to our suggestions. We are so thankful to Kila Manpos and our chairman, Kottakkal Municipality. And also, we will continue this with more perfections. Thank you.
Kottakkal is a municipal town in Malappuram district in Kerala, southern India, having 32 wards. It is located 12 kilometers southwest of Malappuram, the district headquarters, and 15.5 kilometers from Thirur railway station. Coming to the statistics, total number of wards are 32. Total population is 48,342. Child population is 16,158, which is about 33% of our total population. Since they hold a big percentage, we did a lot of programs to solve the existing problems faced by the children. The main projects are enhancing the immunization percentage to 100 up to the age of 5 years. Promising child-friendly atmosphere in all our public health institutions and other institutions. Allotting permanent buildings to all Anganwadis that doesn't have a permanent building. Setting parks, stadium and playground for physical and mental well-being of our children. Allotting funds for their overall well-being. Provide opportunities to frame their needs by make them participate on various WhatsApps, working group and special development seminars. Enhancing their English skill by distributing English-Malayalam dictionaries to all students. Distributed bicycles to the children to enhance their physical activities. These are given to 3,500 children by allotting 10 lakh rupees. Conducted various football coaching camps. Renovated 5 Anganwadis at Korayur, Palathara, Vulliyaparamba, Papai and East Vellore to high-tech model by public contributions. Allotted development fund for various projects for the basic needs of children. Allotted 1,27,22,457 in the year of 2016 to 2017. 2,28,32,408 in the year of 2017 to 2018. 4,43,80,180 in the year of 2018 to 2019. 4,52,67,783 in the year of 2019-2020. Children's made their participation at Community Kitchen, which was working for the laborers from other states during COVID pandemic. All the programs are conducted with great public participation and with their big acceptance.
Myself, Kirtana, Joint Convener of Child Friendly Local Governance in Kottayam Municipality. We are participating in Community Kitchen for migrant laborers regarding COVID-19. Thank you for all.
Myself, Hisham Muhammad, Joint Convener of CFLG Kottayam Municipality. We are participating in all programs of CFLG Kottayam Municipality. Thank you for all.
Our Honorable Minister, Dr. Thomas Isaac, released 20 points development program prepared by our Kottayam Municipal Council. Special wards are conducted in 32 wards twice in a year. 61% of children made their participation there in the ward sabhas. They put forward 101 suggestions. These were approved by the municipal council and accordingly prepared the projects. 15 working groups are conducted by giving importance to children and also conducted development seminars. Distributed health cards and conducted health checkups among 4,000 children for promoting their complete well-being. Able to reach the immunization status among children to 93.3%, which was 60% before. Hence, our overall achievements are raised the immunization status to 93.3% from 60%. Given immunization to 1,768 children. Only 6.7% is not immunized. Conducted meeting and awareness among religious leaders to boost the immunization status more. Given 10 marks as bonus for the families who completed immunization program among their children for beneficiary selection for giving the benefit from the municipality. Renovated CHC using 3.5 crore from MP fund, which was established in the year 1980s. Received Kayakalpa Award for CHC's meritorious service. Coming to the future plans of Kottayam Municipality, activities will be formulated to improve the health and education standard of the children of Kottayam Municipality. Toilets and urinals will be constructed in schools as required. Children's parks and swimming pools will be set up to enhance sportsmanship. Children will be given the opportunity to make suggestions for the project activities of the municipality. Government agencies and public institutions in the municipality will take necessary steps to make them child friendly.
Thank you all the delegates, Kila Director, Dr. Joey Element and Dr. M. Peter Raj and other participating in this program. Thanks again giving me opportunity and participated in the webinar. And special thanks to Mr. Kam Rashid, Kila External Faculty.
Thank you, Kottayam Municipal Chairperson and the team for your good work. Now we move on to the presentation by District Panchayat Thrissur in Central Kerala. The speciality is how a district is trying to emerge as a child-friendly district with the effective coordination of all the local governments of a given district. So here comes a local government evolving as a district leader and odd role a district planning committee can play in that affair. So welcome Madam Mary Thomas, District Panchayat President Thrissur and the Chairperson DPC Thrissur.
എല്ലാവർക്കും നമസ്കാരം. ദേശീയ സെമിനാറിലേക്ക് സ്വാഗതം. ഞാൻ മേരി തോമസ്, തൃശൂർ ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്ത് പ്രസിഡന്റ്.
Children's well-being, prosperity, health and education are the responsibilities of government at different tiers. As we know, children have four fundamental rights: survival, development, protection and participation. With the aim to avail these four fundamental rights to the children, the Thrissur District Panchayat has developed the Child Friendly District Program. The District Planning Committee and the District Panchayat, in collaboration with various institutions like KILA, designed projects. Through close discussion with our local self-governments of Thrissur, we prepared a district plan for the same. Under the action plan, special projects for children were prepared for the comprehensive development of children. One of the important projects was the creation of database of children through web portal. The status of children in the age group between 0 to 18 was collected and compiled. The status of early childhood development, school enrollment, healthy school surrounding, level of child participation, child abuse, etc. can also be understood from 18 indicators provided in the web portal. All the 86 Grama Panchayats, 16 block panchayats, 7 municipalities and 1 corporation actively participated in uploading the data of children through ICT-enabled web portal. The district panchayat as well as other local bodies could make use of the data for planning. Today, at the touch of a finger, data on the conditions of children in Thrissur district is available to us through the web portal. Our first priority was children in the age group between 0 to 3 years. As a part of this, for the first time in Kerala, in collaboration with the LSDs, Social Justice Department and MGNREGS, we were able to complete 200 smart child-friendly Anganwadis in this time frame. We were able to set up water purifiers and air conditioners in all Anganwadis and schools. The next priority was improving the environmental conditions of schools. Provision of good toilets, distribution of napkins to teenage girls, initiatives to reduce mental trauma in children through psychosocial counseling were some of the programs. The supply of hygienic napkins at schools through vending machines were made cost effective through local manufacturing of the same through Women's Local Initiative. Vending machine and incinerator were also set up. Through this, we were able to provide a child-friendly comfortable space in schools to teenage girls. Provision for providing safe drinking water, playing facilities, experimental labs, smart classrooms were set up in every schools. We were able to open up a science museum named Vikyan Sagar, which was an effort to inculcate scientific interest among children and also to provide exposure in scientific achievements for children and public. For creating a science curious community of children, we were setting up science parks in schools. In order to develop an inclusive society, prevention and control of disabilities are given priority in the child-friendly district plan. Early identification, detection, diagnosis and intervention services for all children with differentially ability is conceived as a major project in Thrissur. For
For this purpose, a project called Shubhapti or District Disability Resource Center has set up by District Panchayat for detecting mental and physical disabilities in children at an early age and creating a center for their mothers to work independently. The District Panchayat is ensuring scholarship and supply of aids and appliances to children with differentially ability. Thrissur District Panchayat is doing very significant initiatives to protect the rights of children. Thrissur District Panchayat has produced IEC material and exhibited in various locations of the district. This is to view public awareness of child friendliness. To ensure the right to participation, Balasabhas are constituted in every local government. Through Balasabhas, programs are being planned to educate children on their rights and responsibilities. Special Grama Sabhas for children are convened in all Grama Panchayats and municipalities. Another major issue faced by children is substance abuse. To prevent this, the schools are declared zeros on prohibiting sale of abusive substance. Thrissur District Panchayat has won the best district panchayat in India of the Ministry of Panchayat Raj, Government of India. Achievements of Thrissur District Panchayat: increased child sex ratio from 950 to 968. Specific intervention in malnutrition children, improving their status. Early intervention to identify the disability in children by conducting medical camps. Mobilization of society about child-friendly concept. Future plans of Thrissur District Panchayat: completion of DDRC. Updation of web portal every year. Upgradation of all Anganwadis by implanting air conditioners and water purifiers. Strengthening of special Grama Sabha for children. Formation and strengthening of Jagrata Samiti for protection of children. Reversing sex ratio. സമയത്തിന്റെ
പരിമിതി ഉണ്ടെങ്കിൽ പോലും വളരെ കുറച്ച് കാര്യങ്ങൾ നിങ്ങളുമായി പങ്കുവയ്ക്കാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞിട്ടുള്ള സന്തോഷം പ്രകടിപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഇതിനുള്ള ഒരു അവസരം ഒരുക്കിയിട്ടുള്ള കിലയ്ക്കും അനുബന്ധ സ്ഥാപനങ്ങൾക്കുമെല്ലാം തൃശൂർ ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്തിന്റെ പേരിലുള്ള നന്ദിയും കടപ്പാടും അറിയിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ ഒരു വാക്ക് അവസാനിപ്പിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവർക്കും നന്ദി.
Thank you. We had
over to Trivandrum, Dr. Joy, Director General Kila. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. We had eminent 7 presentations, and now we are going to hear from 3 panelists who are going to reflect on the presentation made by 5 Gram Panchayats and one municipality, and finally the Thrissur District Panchayat. Let me now invite Srimati Shobha Koshi, former chairperson of Kerala State Commission for Protection of Child Rights. Mrs. Shobha Koshi.
Good afternoon. May I first thank Kila and the other organizers for inviting me and giving me this chance to hear first hand about the work that is being done by the local self-government initiative, the child-friendly local panchayat initiative. I have been in some ways a fellow traveler of this initiative way back from 2015, and I have seen it grow till not only during my tenure in up to 2018, but I have even followed it thereafter, being part of a WhatsApp group. And it is one of the groups whose activities I follow diligently every day. By 2017, when the rest of the country woke up to the idea of child-friendly local governance, and the National Commission invited all the commissions to participate and sent to us their parameters or indicators and their idea of what the child-friendly local governance initiative should be, I was forced to tell them that Kerala had moved ahead and that our indicators were far more comprehensive and our benchmarks much higher. So I requested that we may be allowed to continue to be a kind of a support to this initiative rather than participate in the All India initiative. Now, having said that, why is this one particular initiative of particular interest and to me? It is because of that this particular initiative, it reflects the voice of the community. And the voice of the community is most important to create a conducive environment for child rights. It is both immediate and it is both and also relevant. So just now, while listening to the presentations, the president of the Ramapuram Panchayat very rightly mentioned that this whole thing came from an idea that Kila had planted in the minds of all the panchayats in around 2016. And what is really interesting is that not only has the funds been utilized, I mean, people became aware that 5% of the funds can be used for the use of children. But more important than that, as we have seen in the presentation, is the absolute creativity that has gone into issues, into creating projects on issues on which the community or the panchayat focused. We have seen a range of issues. I'm not going to elaborate on them or repeat them, but the range itself is mind-blowing. The kind of space that has been created for children to speak out is and to reflect the needs of children, that is also phenomenal. That has to be acknowledged, and more so during these COVID times. You know, the WhatsApp group was a buzz of activity. We have seen from Valapattanam onwards to everyone the kind of initiatives they have taken to keep children happy and to keep children active. And this is so important, as the minister remarked earlier. We have over 60 deaths of children during this period. Now compare that with the 38 deaths that we had with COVID. So that shows the enormity of the problem. And so the kind of initiatives taken through the child-friendly local governance initiative is really very good. Now, having said that, and having seen the growth, I would just like to take the little time available to me to focus on what next, because it is also important to build on the foundation that we have created in these last few years. I've gone back to the 20 indicators that were taken at the time of the start of the initiative, and I'm just going to flag 4 issues. The first one is updation of data. I was very happy to see that there is a tremendous effort being made to update the data. But I have a suggestion that the minister remarked today in her opening remarks that the government wants to do more and more projects for the vulnerable in the local government area. But if that is so, it is very important that we have proper desegregated data, so that we know the kind of vulnerabilities that children suffer in a particular panchayat or municipality or even in a district. So my request is this updation of data, if it could be done very systematically and regularly and desegregated, I think that would be very helpful. The second thing is about child-friendly public space. Notice that much initiatives are being taken for creating child-friendly public space for children. But from the photographs also, I noticed that there is need for a greater gender perspective, because if you for a healthy child, it was mentioned that a child should not only just be educated, but should be given opportunities to develop other aspects of his or her personality. It is the girl child that very often does not have adequate, safe public space. So my request is to everyone concerned that can we have a greater gender perspective when we are doing child-friendly public spaces in the future. It's a good beginning, but can we do more? The third one is about child protection. You know, there is a requirement under the Juvenile Justice Act for village-level protection committees to be set up. I think there is a need for that to be active. Minister again mentioned that this is one of the burdens that we in Kerala face, child abuse. It's something that is something not easy to tackle because very often the abuse happens not in the public space, but within the four walls of the home. But there is no one better than the local village community which can address this issue. So not only for preventive issues, but even to in the matter of, you know, ensuring that the offender gets punished. Very often in Kerala, we weep and we wail with somebody we find who has committed an offense gets away because the follow-up has not been absolutely pakka enough to see that they get punished in the judicial process. But this is where village level protection committees can definitely play a big role, both in the prevention and in the ensuring of justice. And that these two are key elements for ensuring the protection of children. And last but not the least, you see, we have all over India, we have a problem. Maintenance of what the assets we create is not really something that is a big priority in our setup. And it is nothing, I mean, it is not, I mean, it is, how shall I put it? It is best reflected, let me say, in the state of the toilets in schools. We built beautiful toilets. We provide water. But what happens is that we do not maintain it. Maintenance of buildings, it's not only an issue here, we are better, I would say, than most places, but still across India, in all buildings, we find that maintenance is an issue. I have, in the course of reading through this program yesterday, I noticed that the Ministry of Rural Development is now giving an award for the best child-friendly local governance initiative. That set me thinking, sir, with the minister sitting there, sir, I have a suggestion. So why don't we think of giving an award at the district level, at least, to the best maintained office, schools in terms of toilets, in terms of the buildings, in terms of the grounds, so that the children find that and they are safe, because all said and done, this is the largest congregated place where children congregate for the longest part of a day. So how do we make them safe? We do keep having an occasional incident or two where we know it was totally preventable accidents. So, and also menstrual hygiene is very important. So, and very often what happens is that unless you have water and a clean toilet, we cannot really ensure this. So when we talk about ensuring good use of toilets and water for in the village, can we also think of the school as a subset and see how we can do it by rewarding the people who will promote this concept? There's nothing more. I would like to take up more time because I know there are experts waiting to talk. I thank you once again for inviting me to this.
For those four important points that you consider as important for taking, for building further to the achievements which these local bodies have already made. And I think the minister has noted your idea of a competition an award at the district level for the best maintained, you know, project. Now, may I invite Sri G. Balagopal, former country representative of UNICEF, to offer his feedback on the presentations.
Thank you very much, sir. I would like to first compliment all the local governments who have made the presentation today for doing so in such an excellent fashion, so that it was very easy for the several people outside Kerala who are listening to this program and seeing the program to understand and get inspired from the excellent presentations and the inspiring statements that we have seen before us. My task, while thanking Dr. Joy and his colleagues for giving me this opportunity, I also echo what Shobha Madam had said, that it has been a great privilege to be associated with KILA and the child-friendly local government programs over the last few years, and to see it growing from strength to strength, getting rooted and providing all the variety of success that we have seen. Today, what I will do is very briefly some of the learnings which have been presented by the seven local government agencies over a few broad areas to make it easy for us to digest for people outside the state. I think the most significant learning from this local child-friendly governance system or initiative is the importance that our elected representatives or local bodies have gained by listening to the voices of children. And this is not something which is very traditional in our culture, but through the Balasabhas and the work done at the very grassroots level, the voices of children were heard, they were taken into account in the planning process, which, as we all know, in Kerala it's been a unique strength of planning at the grassroots level. And that has been influenced. And that is why we saw this significant escalation of resources, which, of course, apart from the 5%, which is mandatory, we have seen how, say, Ramapuram, I had seen from their report that the investment for children's issues had grown from 35 lakhs in 2015-16 to over 1 crore in 2019-20. Kotakel described similarly a large increase in their investment. And these investments are going to the most valuable sector, that is the future of our society, in building better health, better intellectual capacities, better life skills, and better resilience to deal with all the problems that the next generation are going to take over and hopefully solve in an even better fashion than we have been able to do, number one. Number two is, I think, the lesson of having for us to go an extra mile to focus on the problems of children who face special disadvantages in our society. And these are the children of the tribal communities, the differently abled children, the children of migrant labor. And you see this in the range of interventions that were presented here today. Particularly for differently abled children, I don't think the presentation Trishur had done had given enough prominence to something very particularly important, that they have started early detection of disabilities soon after birth. They have set up a resource center, a dedicated resource center for helping children with disabilities, and they provide 100% disability scholarships in Thrissur district. So this is an example which is worth emulating all over the country, in my opinion. The other initiatives we have seen, how special reach is made to children from the tribal communities to reduce the dropout and absenteeism, which is one of the problems that these children face in keeping up with other children from the non-tribal communities. Now coming to COVID, and I have been most impressed by the recent, whatever I have heard here, on the initiatives that almost all the local governments have taken to keep children engaged with education and to maintain a continuity in the normalcy of life, which is disrupted because children cannot go to school anymore physically. They miss the bonding together of their peers, community, and their ability to play games and so on. This has been fantastic. The online has been a lifesaver being able to sustain education. But I must also flag here one great danger, which is only beginning to be perceived, that is the online predation of children. Children are being targeted by people who want to abuse them. Child pornography is being circulated. So we have to be alert when children have access to online communication devices that they are not becoming prey to this type of predatory activities. And for which I was very happy to discuss with Director General earlier that some excellent work which is being done in Kerala between Kerala Police and some specialist groups have already produced some very good material, including posters, small films, which can describe how these children can be better protected. And I would request whoever is listening to this program may like to contact Kila, Director General, to see if they want to have this sort of material disseminated. And Kila, I hope, will be able to make that available soon. Number three is about immunization. Honorable Minister, during her statement, had said that Kerala is proud to have one of the best records, but has unfortunately seen a drop in immunization rates in some places where there are some resistance to immunization. I think Kottakkal today has to be particularly complimented that they raised immunization rates from 60% to 93.3%. And they have done it through very innovative means, like giving this 10 bonus marks for fully immunized children in selection of individual beneficiaries. And these are examples which others could also pick up. Very importantly, the Honorable Minister had also underlined abuse that exists, particularly within families, and how this matter requires attention. And I must say, having worked for a decade in child protection globally, that many people look to Kerala for leadership in this area of protection of children from various types of abuse and violence and so on. And what we design here are some of our responses to problems which other parts of India are not facing today, but will definitely face very much tomorrow when all of these things come up. I'm very happy to see the repeated reference to activities which countering drug abuse. How many of the local governments have located that and working with police and excise department in vulnerability mapping, as we have heard one of the gram panchayats, I'm sorry if I didn't get the name correctly, promotion of sports as an activity which would counter these type of attractions is one. Very importantly, I was so happy to see fostering of better community relations by young people. And the example that Kottakkal mentioned in the presentation of having youngsters participate in the community kitchen, that was a very wonderful thing. And Ramapuram had also said about, among other things, caring for each other. I think that is what our community badly requires, a coming together of all the disparate communities and differences in one place and one group, and fostering that community feeling. And finally, I would like to say about innovations, and that is, Shobha Koshi Madam said, so many new things have happened. The water bell was something very significant. I had not known about it. That children carry safe water from the homes, bell is rung, and they drink water, because very often children do not drink enough water. I found that Katakada had a very good example of the graduates of Anganwadi centers coming together in an association. I think it's a wonderful thing. Katakada didn't get a chance to very much speak about it, but that is a great thing. And I think, again, sending volunteers to help in palliative care centers. Again, a great humanitarian exposure, which shapes the mindset and prepares these children to be citizens of a much more caring and a world where people come together and are not divisive in future. So let me once again thank you and stop this now.
Thank you, Sri Balagopal, for highlighting those important initiatives, the five of them. And I think there is much for other Lok Panchayat local bodies also to learn from it. Thank you very much. Now, let me invite Dr. C. Kadireshan, Associate Professor of National Institute of Rural Development, to make his points.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. First of all, my sincere thanks to Dr. Joy Alaman, KILA team, for inviting me, particularly involving NIRDPR, National Institute of Rural Development, Panchayat Raj, in this very important and wonderful webinar, actually. Because we always never miss the webinars organized by KILA and their partner institutions. This particular webinar is very unique for us because we never undertake this type of very intensive and very focused subject in a national level, actually. Though this is a very important subject, there are other important subjects we always overpower this thing, and we will give very least importance and other thing. And it has become in the list of 7th or 8th in our activity, something like that. When he called yesterday and day for yesterday, when you are talking about this particular thing, I readily agreed to be a part of this webinar because each and every, always the Gram Panchayats are learning ground for us, particularly Kerala Gram Panchayats. They are doing very wonderful work, actually. So I thought actually there are certain prescribed norms will be there for child-friendly panchayat, mainly for the award purpose. Many panchayats are work, and mainly with the support of UNICEF and other organizations, these panchayats are working. But after listening each and every, these five Gram Panchayat and the Kottakkal municipality, and also the district panchayat Thrissur, I understood that they are really involved. Actually, they are really involved in deep into the subject, and the panchayat leadership on all three levels. So it is showing very clearly here. I was really mesmerized the way the number of activities carried out by all these gram panchayats, municipality, and district things. And everybody is unique in their sense, and every Gram Panchayat here, they shown some unique things learning for everybody, actually. So particularly NIRDPR, we are very happy to take forward so much of learnings from these Gram Panchayats, which we really look forward to take it forward to other Gram Panchayats, which we are working in other states, actually. So I just highlight quickly to mention two, three important points, actually, particularly the children's forum. I found it's very unique and involvement of creating a very beautiful children's library in the Gram Panchayat library, and creating child awareness and child rights and awareness and other thing in the form of UNARU, the RISE program, which Valapattanam Gram Panchayat Kannur was very unique for me, actually. In case of Peravurur Kannur, I thought actually there are two important things which was very unique compared to other panchayats, actually, which is like giving much importance to sports, physical activity, keeping them away from mobile phone addiction. This is a need of the hour, actually. So I think 80% of the children in the Gram Panchayat, we know that very well, they're really addicted everywhere. They're not moving out to meet their friends and other thing also. So this giving much importance early morning and the 7 o'clock in the sports activity and other thing, and giving importance that cultivating the organic vegetable in the school level. So which give them the responsibility and their sense of pride they're creating among the children, actually. We have to salute this leadership from Peravur, actually. And in case of Kolali Gram Panchayat, what I saw is unique thing is there is a 40% allotment of the fund, which is never I heard about this thing, particularly for the children, focusing on children and integrating it part of their planning exercise, DPDP, which was very unique for it. Apart from that, they had done a wonderful job, like a smart classroom and other things like that. And the Ramabram GP, which they repeatedly mentioned two, three times, the president mentioned that KILA has given a very clear-cut guidelines, the way it has to be implemented. I think they very strictly they made a planning and they succeeded actually. The way of survival, development, security and participation, this was very unique. And particularly I was very very happy to note the things they are repeatedly mentioning that they are conducting a 3 days workshop, which is very interesting and which is a need very much needed for all the gram panchayat. When you bring, you wanted to bring all the children under one umbrella, maybe different wards from different schools, something this type of 3 days workshop will really create a real long-term impact. It's a lifetime opportunity for the children actually. It creates the leadership things and how they should be a part of the local government process. This I found very unique actually. And Kattakada Gram Panchayat in Thiruvananthapuram, the nutritional food, the Anganwadis are providing very high-tech thing, the nutritional food thing, and the palliative care. And my earlier panelist, sir, also was mentioning that special importance to the disabled people and the other thing, and the what are the efforts the panchayat is making, this thing is very important. And also the children's parliament, actually, this is a very unique thing. And Kottakkal municipality, of course, many times we used to see in the newspaper also, the community kitchen concept and the students' health cards, which is a very first time they introduced this model exclusively by a municipality. And Thrissur, actually, as a whole district has adopted, and they are very serious about creating a lot of children's parks, science museum, science parks, and all the things were very unique for me, actually. It was a very good learning for us to take forward this thing, actually. So I think we know that we always take Kerala as a model and example to take it forward, that how they achieved the panchayat. Panchayat are the main leaders in creating the change process in the whole country and other thing like that. Particularly, we always believe that the convergence and collective action, which in terms of taking into the planning exercise, GPDP, is going to work everywhere. So though in 2018, the Government of India, Ministry of Panchayat Raj, they put the new guidelines of GPDP, Gram Panchayat Development Plan, an exclusive section is there in the guidelines where they are repeatedly saying that like woman-centric development and also the child-friendly Gram Panchayat should be thing. We had an opportunity to work with UNICEF also very shortly in few Gram Panchayat in Punjab and other areas. So everywhere we are trying to teach this aspect something like that. So the GPDP is going to be a main carrier, and the way we take the NIRDP are taking GPDP as a main vehicle for change something, where child-friendly Gram Panchayat also is becoming a very important component now. It is a very right time for us that all the learnings from this webinar and other things, we will definitely will be taking it to the part of our GPDP programs, and we will like to work very closely with Kila also to take this as a model. This thing is one important point. What not much importance was given in Kerala this presentation is particularly on Poshan Abhiyan actually, regarding nutritional issues and also WASH and other programs. Maybe they touched everywhere, but other than that, the leadership things were very unique, and it was very highlighting in all the Gram Panchayats. And there should be some things where you'll get a lot of support from Government of India also on nutritional aspects, improving the nutritional aspects, creating horticulture-based kitchen gardens, where I think Kudumbashree is already supporting in all the schools. They're creating these models, I think. Otherwise, in the overall, it was a unique learning experience. And thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Kadireshan. I think from the three panelists, it is evident that all of them are highly impressed by your performance and what you have presented. And no amount or any amount of compliments may not be an excess. I just want to add one important point, which I felt is that what Dr. Sri Balgopal said, the importance of the voice of children being heard. Sitting here, I was thinking that when you are willing to listen to children, you belong to a generation of what is called a no generation, because your parents never ever wanted to listen from you. That is a different time altogether. That generation is making a paradigm shift. That is something very important. Some of you got the awards, and I am very sure others, it's for the others, it's a matter of time. So now I would like to, our Honorable Finance Minister is here. I would like to invite him for a brief interaction with you, and over to Professor Dr. Thomas Isaac.
I want to raise four questions. And you can answer them, respond in Malayalam, doesn't matter. Joseph should translate. നാല് ചോദ്യങ്ങൾ ചോദിക്കുക ഉദ്ദേശിക്കുകയാണ്. അത് കൃത്യമായിട്ട് മലയാളത്തിൽ പറഞ്ഞാലും കുഴപ്പമില്ല. ഫസ്റ്റ് ഈസ് റിഗാർഡിംഗ് ദ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ്. കോലഴി പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഐ തിങ്ക് റെഫേർ ടു ഇറ്റ്. ഐ വുഡ് ലൈക്ക് ടു നോ ഹൗ ഡിഡ് യു ഡു ദ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് ആൻഡ് വാട്ട് വർ ദ ഫൈൻഡിങ്സ്. കോലഴി പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഈ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് നടത്തിയതായിട്ട് പറഞ്ഞു. അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് ചെയ്തതെന്ന് എനിക്ക് അറിയാനായിട്ട് താല്പര്യമുണ്ട്. Second is regarding the migrant children. I think Peravur or Valavattanam had even a slide on them. But I didn't get to know what exactly you did for that. What was the project for the migrant children? എന്താണ് ഈ മൈഗ്രൻ്റ് ചിൽഡ്രന് വേണ്ടി ചെയ്തത്, ആ പ്രൊജക്റ്റ് എന്തായിരുന്നു എന്നറിയാൻ എനിക്ക് താല്പര്യമുണ്ട്. And മൂന്നാമത്തത് is to Trichu. See, it was a district-wide program. Was it a joint project with the local Grama Panchayats or an independent project with the district panchayat? If it was a joint project, what percentage of your outlay would have been integrated to Grama Panchayats? That's the question. Very manasilayam niyayarikimu. The joint project ayirundengil etra shathamanam ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തായിട്ട് ഇൻ്റഗ്രേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് ചെലവഴിച്ചതാണ്. ആൻഡ് ഫൈനലി എ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ ടു എവ്രി വൺ ഓഫ് യു. വെൻ വി സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ഓൺ ദി പീപ്പിൾസ് പ്ലാനിങ് ഡീസെൻട്രലൈസേഷൻ, അംഗനവാടീസ് ഫോർ ദി ഫോക്കസ് ഓഫ് ഇൻ്റർവെൻഷൻ. നൗ യു കനോട്ട് ജസ്റ്റ് ഗെറ്റ് ഫോക്കസ്ഡ് ഓൺ അംഗനവാടീസ് അലോൺ. ഇറ്റ്സ് ഗുഡ് ദറ്റ് വി ഡൈവേഴ്സിഫൈ. ബട്ട് ഐ വാസ് സർപ്രൈസ്ഡ് ദറ്റ് ഓൺലി four presentations made a mention of Anganwadis. Now, I'm certain something's must have been happening. Quality, that was a focal point of intervention. Katakada had certain innovative interventions on, and Trichur also mentioned it. Now, is there any particular reason? Do you find any difficulty in intervening innovatively in the Anganwadi system? It's indeed a transferred institution. So if there is anything, I would like to know about it. These are the four questions. Maybe I'll respond after hearing from your, you know, answers. Thank you.
കോലഴി ആദ്യത്തെ ചോദ്യം എല്ലാവർക്കും
അംഗനവാടിയെ കുറിച്ച് ചോദിച്ചാൽ മനസ്സിലായിക്കണമെന്ന് കരുതുന്നു. നമ്മൾ തുടങ്ങിയപ്പോൾ എല്ലാവരും കുട്ടികളുടെ എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ അംഗനവാടിയാണ്. പക്ഷെ ഇപ്പൊ മാറിയിട്ടുണ്ട്, നാല് പേര് മാത്രമേ പരാമർശിച്ച് കണ്ടുള്ളൂ. കോലഴിക്ക് വളരെ പ്രാധാന്യത്തോടെയുണ്ട്. എൻ്റെ ചോദ്യം, എന്തെങ്കിലും തടസ്സങ്ങളുണ്ടോ നൂതനമായ രീതിയിൽ അംഗനവാടിയിൽ ഇടപെടുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട്? അങ്ങനെ വല്ലതും ഉണ്ടായതുകൊണ്ടാണോ ഇത് പുറകോട്ട് പോയിട്ടുള്ളത്? അല്ല, പ്രസൻറ്റേഷന് വിട്ടുപോയതാണോ? എല്ലാ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തുകളും അംഗനവാടിയുടെ ഫീഡിങ്ങിനും മറ്റും മാൻഡേറ്ററി ആയിട്ട് പണം നീക്കി വെക്കാൻ നിർബന്ധിതരാണ്. സോ അത് ആ ബന്ധമുണ്ട്. പക്ഷെ മൂന്ന് പഞ്ചായത്തുകൾ മാത്രമേ എന്തെങ്കിലും നൂതനമായ രീതിയിൽ അംഗനവാടിയിൽ ഇടപെടുന്നതായിട്ട് പരാമർശിക്കുകയുണ്ടായുള്ളൂ. അതാണ് അവസാനം പറഞ്ഞത്. ഓക്കെ,
കോലഴി പഞ്ചായത്തിന് എങ്ങനെയാണ് വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് നടത്തിയത് എന്നുള്ളതിനെ സംബന്ധിച്ച് അത് നിങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞ കാര്യമാണ്, അതാണ് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിക്കുന്നത്. എന്തെങ്കിലും ഇപ്പെട്ടെന്ന് പ്രതികരിക്കാനുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ പറയുക. കോലഴി പഞ്ചായത്ത്. അല്ലെങ്കിൽ നമുക്ക് വളപട്ടണം തുടങ്ങാം. കോലഴി റെഡിയാണോ? കോലഴി റെഡിയാണോ?
Kolari is having some connectivity issues.
എങ്കിലും നമുക്ക് അടുത്ത ചോദ്യം മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിച്ചത് മൈഗ്രന്റ്
ഹലോ
മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിച്ചത് കേക്കാമോ മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിച്ചത് നിങ്ങളുടെ പഞ്ചായത്തില് വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് നടത്തി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു അതെങ്ങനെയാണ് നടത്തിയത് ഒന്ന് വിശദീകരിക്കാമോ എന്നാണ് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിക്കുക അത് മറ്റുള്ളവർക്കും വളരെ പ്രയോജനപ്രദമാകുമല്ലോ അതാണ്
ഹലോ പീറ്റർ കില ഈ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് ഏതെങ്കിലും മോഡൽ കൊടുത്തിരുന്നിട്ടുണ്ടോ
സർ നമ്മൾ വി സ്റ്റാർട്ടഡ് ആക്ച്വലി വിത്ത് മാരാരിക്കുളം സൗത്ത് ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത്
അതെ അത് ഞാൻ ചെയ്തതാണ്
അതെ സെയിം സെയിം യുവർ ഓൺ മോഡൽ വി ടുക്ക് ഇറ്റ് ആൻഡ് വി ടുക്ക് ഇറ്റ് ആസ് പാർട്ട് ഓഫ് ദി ട്രെയിനിങ് പ്രോഗ്രാം
ദാറ്റ്സ് ഫൈൻ ആൻഡ് ഐ സേ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ഇമ്പോർട്ടന്റ് ദാറ്റ് ഇഫ് യു ആർ തിങ്കിങ് ഓഫ് ഡൂയിങ് എ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് ഫോർ ദി ചിൽഡ്രൻ അത് സ്ത്രീകളുടെയും കുട്ടികളുടെയും ഒരുമിച്ചെടുക്കുന്നതല്ല ബിക്കോസ് സ്ത്രീകളാണ് റെസ്പോണ്ടൻസ് ആയിട്ട് വരാം ആ നോ സോ ഇഫ് യു ആർ തിങ്കിങ് ഓഫ് ഡൂയിങ് എ വൾനറബിലിറ്റി മാപ്പിംഗ് ഫോർ ദി ചിൽഡ്രൻ ഇറ്റ് ഷുഡ് ബി കണ്ടക്റ്റഡ് ഫോർ വിമൻ ആൻഡ് ചിൽഡ്രൻ ടുഗദർ ബിക്കോസ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ബി ദ വിമൻ ഹു വിൽ ബി ദ റെസ്പോണ്ടൻസ് വാട്ട് വി ഹാഡ് ഡൺ ഇൻ മാരാരിക്കുളം ദാറ്റ്സ് ഇൻ മൈ കോൺസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യുവൻസി ദ പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഈസ് ദാറ്റ് ആഫ്റ്റർ ഹോൾ എക്സസൈസ് ഓഫ് കോൺസെൻട്രേഷൻ ടോക്കിംഗ് ടേക്കിംഗ് ക്ലാസസ് ഓഫ് വേരിയസ് ടൈപ്സ് ഓഫ് വയലൻസ് അഗൈൻസ്റ്റ് വിമൻ each woman would drop in a box their record on the last 2-4 months of the type of violences they faced the context the time the perpetrator who did the violence and so on in a format without they don't have to reveal their identity at all and most revealing information from that mapping was okay then we mapped it on the village ward where exactly violence were taking place and so on but the most say kind of shocking revelation was as the age decreases the violence increases various types of violence increases and when it reached the high school students 100% of the students said in the last 4 months they have faced some violence or other in terms of either verbal abuse or physical or Balagopal mentioned in the family is there a particular time say between the school closing at 4 and 7 o'clock when the parents return these 3 hours are very problematic hours in the house in fact that is some most shocking revelation And the panchayat then, on the basis of that, formulated projects to face this violence against the women and children. So I wanted to know if you had devised any other methodology for mapping the violence against abuse of children and violence against women. That's okay. Fine. Let's go ahead.
Valabattanam, adutha chodyam, Valabattanam grama panchayathinodu sambandhiyana. നിങ്ങൾ പറഞ്ഞു മൈഗ്രൻ്റ് കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് മൈഗ്രൻസിൻ്റെ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട് ചില പ്രോഗ്രാംസ് നടത്തിയെന്ന് പറഞ്ഞു അതെന്താണ് ഒന്ന് വിശദീകരിക്കാമോ അതാണ് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിച്ചേക്കുന്നത്
ഞങ്ങൾ വളവട്ടണം പഞ്ചായത്ത് ലൈബ്രറിയുടെ കീഴിൽ ചിൽഡ്രൻസിൻ്റെ ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പുണ്ട് ആ ഗ്രൂപ്പിലെ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് കുട്ടികളോടൊപ്പം തന്നെ മൈഗ്രൻസായി 20 കുട്ടികൾ പങ്കെടുത്തിരുന്നു ഞങ്ങളുടെ വളവട്ടണം പഞ്ചായത്തിൽ താമസിക്കുന്ന മറ്റ് സംസ്ഥാനങ്ങളിൽ വരുന്നതായ കുട്ടികളാണ് അവർ വളവട്ടണം പഞ്ചായത്തിലെ സ്കൂളുകളിലാണ് പഠിക്കുന്നത് അപ്പോൾ അവർ കുറേ ആവശ്യങ്ങൾ അവരുടെ അവർക്ക് വേണ്ടി പറഞ്ഞിരുന്നു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് അവർക്ക് വിദ്യാഭ്യാസത്തിന് നമ്മുടെ സംസ്ഥാനത്തിലുള്ള കുട്ടികൾക്ക് കിട്ടുന്ന ആനുകൂല്യങ്ങളൊന്നും അവർക്ക് കിട്ടുന്നില്ല. ആ അതിന്റെ ബേസിസ് അന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ നമ്മുടെ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് കളക്ടർ ഉണ്ടായിരുന്നു, അദ്ദേഹത്തെയും കൂടെ ക്ഷണിച്ചിരുന്നു ഈ സദസ്സിലേക്ക്. അദ്ദേഹത്തിന് മുമ്പിൽ തന്നെ ആ വന്ന കുട്ടികളിൽ നിന്ന് ഒരു തുളസി എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞൊരു കുട്ടി വളരെ നന്നായിട്ട് പ്രസന്റ് ചെയ്തു. അതായത് അവർ നന്നായിട്ട് പഠിക്കണമെന്നുണ്ട്, പക്ഷെ നമ്മുടെ പഞ്ചായത്ത് നമ്മുടെ സ്റ്റേറ്റിൽ നിന്നും നമ്മുടെ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് കിട്ടുന്ന ആനുകൂല്യങ്ങൾ അത്തരം കുട്ടികൾക്ക് കിട്ടുന്നില്ല. ചിലർക്ക് ജാതിയുടെ സർട്ടിഫിക്കറ്റ്, വരുമാന സർട്ടിഫിക്കറ്റ് ഇങ്ങനത്തെ കാര്യങ്ങളൊന്നും കിട്ടുന്നില്ല എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞപ്പോൾ അത് കളക്ടർ അസിസ്റ്റന്റ് കളക്ടറെ ശ്രദ്ധയപ്പെടുത്തുകയും അദ്ദേഹം അത് ഏറ്റെടുക്കുകയും ഈ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് ആവശ്യമായ എല്ലാ കാര്യവും റേഷൻ കാർഡ് പോലും കിട്ടാത്ത ഒരവസ്ഥയുണ്ടായിരുന്നു അവർക്ക്. വളരെ കാലങ്ങളായിട്ട് ഇവിടെ താമസിക്കുന്ന ആളുകളാണ്, പക്ഷെ അവർക്ക് റേഷൻ പോലും കിട്ടുന്നില്ല, വരുമാന സർട്ടിഫിക്കറ്റ് കിട്ടുന്നില്ല. ഇങ്ങനെ ജാതി
പ്രസിഡന്റ്, ആ കുട്ടികൾ പഠിക്കാൻ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകുന്നുണ്ടോ?
ആ ഉണ്ട്, പഠിക്കാൻ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകുന്ന മാത്രം നല്ല ഡിഗ്രി എടുത്ത കുട്ടികൾ വരെ ഉണ്ട് ഇപ്പോ. നമ്മുടെ വളവട്ടത്ത് തന്നെ താമസിച്ച് വളവട്ടം സാധാരണ സ്കൂളുകളിൽ പഠിച്ച് ഗവൺമെന്റ് സ്കൂളിലൊക്കെ പഠിച്ചിട്ട് തന്നെ നല്ല നിലയിലെത്തി കുട്ടികളുണ്ട് അവിടെ. 20 കുട്ടികൾ അന്ന് വന്നിരുന്നു, വളരെ നന്നായിട്ട് പഠിക്കുന്ന കുട്ടികൾ, നന്നായിട്ട് മലയാളം സംസാരിക്കും, മലയാളം എഴുതുകയൊക്കെ ചെയ്യും.
ഇത് പെർമനന്റ് ആയിട്ട് താമസിക്കുന്നവരാ, ടെമ്പററി ആയിട്ട് വരുന്നവര് എങ്ങനെയാണ്? ആ കുട്ടികൾ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകും, ഒരു വർഷത്തേക്ക് രണ്ട് വർഷത്തേക്കൊക്കെ വരുന്നവരില്ലേ, അവരുടെ കുട്ടികൾ സ്കൂളിൽ പോകുന്നുണ്ടോ?
ഞങ്ങളുടെ പഞ്ചായത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾ അറിഞ്ഞിടത്തോളം കുട്ടികളെയൊക്കെ സ്കൂളിൽ അയക്കാറുണ്ട്. ഈ ഭാഗത്തുള്ളതായ മൈഗ്രൻസിന്റെ കൂടെ കുടുംബമായിട്ട് വന്നിരിക്കുന്ന ആളുകളുടെ കുട്ടികളെ എല്ലാവരും സ്കൂളിലേക്ക് അയക്കുന്ന ഒരു സംവിധാനം നമ്മൾ ചെയ്യാറുണ്ട്, അറിഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ചെയ്യുന്നതാണത്. കാരണം അവർ കുറച്ചു കാലമെങ്കിലും കുറച്ചു കാലം നമ്മുടെ വിദ്യാലയങ്ങളിൽ പഠിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് അവർ നല്ല ഉയർന്ന നിലയിൽ മാർക്ക് വാങ്ങുന്ന കുട്ടികളും ഉണ്ട് ആ കൂട്ടത്തില്. മലയാള ഭാഷ ശരിക്കും നന്നായി സംസാരിക്കുന്ന കുട്ടികളും ഉണ്ട് അവര്. അങ്ങനെ കളക്ടർ ശ്രദ്ധയപ്പെടുത്തിയതിനു ശേഷം അവർക്ക് ആവശ്യമായ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ ചെയ്തു കൊടുക്കാൻ നമ്മുടെ പഞ്ചായത്തിന് ലൈബ്രറിക്ക് വേണ്ടി സാധിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്.
The president said is that first of all they ensured that all the migrant children, regardless of the duration of their stay in the Valapattanam, they ensured that all the children reaches the school. And in the meeting, and they had something like 20 migrant children, and those children, they are not as endowed like other children, and some of them were not having ration cards even. So what the village panchayat ensured was that they made the presence of the sub collector in such meetings, and the issues faced by these children were brought to the attention of the sub collector concerned, and these problems, their problems were resolved. That is what the president said. So they had a special focus. They ensured that the migrant children, the children of the guest workers, are treated on par with our own children. That is the important point. And now coming to തൃശ്ശൂരുകാരോട് മിനിസ്റ്റർ ചോദിച്ച ചോദ്യം എന്ന് പറഞ്ഞാൽ, അവിടെ നടത്തിയ പരിപാടികളിൽ എങ്ങനെയാണ് മറ്റ് ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തുകളെ ഇൻവോൾവ് ചെയ്തത്? അവർ ഇൻവോൾവ് ചെയ്തെങ്കിൽ മൊത്തം നടന്ന പരിപാടിയിൽ എത്ര ശതമാനം കോസ്റ്റ് പഞ്ചായത്തുകളാണ് വഹിച്ചത്? അപ്പോൾ അവരുമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു ഇൻവോൾവ്മെൻറ്റ്, അവരുമായിട്ടുള്ള ഒരു കോർഡിനേഷൻ, അതൊക്കെ എങ്ങനെയാണ് സാധ്യമായത് എന്നാണ് ചോദിച്ചത്.
ബാലസൗഹൃദ ജില്ലയുടെ പ്രോജക്റ്റ് ഞങ്ങളൊരു കേൾക്കാമോ?
കേൾക്കാം കേൾക്കാം.
ബാലസൗഹൃദ ജില്ലയുടെ പ്രോജക്റ്റ് ഞങ്ങൾ എടുത്തത് ജില്ലാ പദ്ധതി ആയിട്ടാണ് എടുത്തത്. ഇപ്പൊ ജില്ലാ പദ്ധതി എന്ന് പറയുമ്പോൾ ഡി പി സിക്കാണ് അതിന്റെ കോർഡിനേഷന്റെ ഒരു ചുമതലയുള്ളത്. അതുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മുടെ 86 ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തുകള്, 16 ബ്ലോക്ക് പഞ്ചായത്തുകള്, 7 മുനിസിപ്പാലിറ്റി, 1 കോർപ്പറേഷൻ, അതുപോലെ ഡിസ്ട്രിക്ട് പഞ്ചായത്ത്, ഇങ്ങനെ ഇതെല്ലാം കൂടി ചേർന്നുകൊണ്ട് ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തുകള് ഒരു 50,000 രൂപ വെച്ച്, ബ്ലോക്ക് പഞ്ചായത്തുകൾ 100,000, 7 മുനിസിപ്പാലിറ്റി 500,000 വെച്ച്, കോർപ്പറേഷൻ 1,000,000, ഡിസ്ട്രിക്ട് പഞ്ചായത്ത് 50,000, അങ്ങനെ 1,54,00,000 പ്രോജക്റ്റാണ് ഞങ്ങൾ ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ജില്ലാ പദ്ധതി എന്നുള്ള രീതിയിൽ ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്ത് നേതൃത്വം കൊടുത്തുകൊണ്ട് അതിലൊരു പദ്ധതിയാണ് ഞങ്ങൾ തയ്യാറാക്കിയത്. അതിൻ്റെ ഭാഗമായിട്ട് ഞങ്ങൾ ആദ്യമായി ചെയ്തത് ഡിസ്ട്രിക്ട് പഞ്ചായത്ത് അർജിത ഓൾ ദി ലോക്കൽ സെൽഫ് ഗവൺമെന്റ് ഇൻസ്റ്റിറ്റ്യൂഷൻസ് ടു ക്രിയേറ്റ് എ വർക്കിംഗ് ഗ്രൂപ്പ് ഫോർ ചൈൽഡ് ഫ്രണ്ട്ലി ഗ്രൂപ്പ്. വി ക്രിയേറ്റഡ് എ പെർഫോർമ with the help of experts to find out the statistics which found out the problems facing the children. Then district panchayat requested to form a Bal Sabha to all local self-governments. Working group discussed this matter in detail and according to the resolution created in discussions, the working group formed the project Child Friendly District. District Planning Committee, DPC, approved this project and requested all LSGs to cooperate with district panchayat to implement the above Child Friendly District. അതിൻ്റെ ഭാഗമായിട്ടുള്ള പദ്ധതികൾ നമ്മുടെ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് അതുപോലെ എല്ലാ നമ്മുടെ ലോക്കൽ ബോഡീസിലും അതിൻ്റെ ഭാഗമായിട്ടുള്ള പദ്ധതികൾ ആവിഷ്കരിച്ച് നടപ്പാക്കി. ആദ്യമായിട്ട് ഞങ്ങൾ നടത്തിയത് ഒരു വെബ് പോർട്ടൽ തയ്യാറാക്കുക എന്നുള്ളതായിരുന്നു. അപ്പം നമ്മുടെ ഈ ലോക്കൽ സെൽഫ് ഗവൺമെൻറ്റുകളുമായി ബന്ധപ്പെട്ടുകൊണ്ട് അതാത് ലോക്കൽ ബോഡീസിലുള്ള കുട്ടികൾ 0 മുതൽ 18 വയസ്സ് വരെ പ്രായമായിട്ടുള്ള കുട്ടികൾ ഉൾപ്പെടുത്തിക്കൊണ്ടുള്ള വെബ് പോർട്ടൽ, ആ വെബ് പോർട്ടലിൽ നമ്മുടെ ഗവൺമെൻറ് എഞ്ചിനീയറിംഗ് കോളേജിലെ സ്റ്റുഡൻസിൻ്റെയും ഒപ്പം കിളിയുടെയും സഹായത്തിൽ പ്രസൻറ്റ് സ്റ്റാറ്റസ്, നമ്മുടെ കുട്ടികളെ കുറിച്ചുള്ള പ്രസൻറ്റ് സ്റ്റാറ്റസ് എടുക്കുകയും അതിനുശേഷം എന്ത് പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളാണ് മുന്നോട്ട് കൊണ്ടുപോകുന്നതിനെ കുറിച്ചിട്ട് വീണ്ടും കർമ്മസമിതികൾ കൂടി തീരുമാനിക്കുകയുണ്ടായി. അതിൻ്റെ ഭാഗമായിട്ടാണ് ഏറ്റവും ചെറിയ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾ, അതായത് 0 മുതൽ 3 വരെ പ്രായമായിട്ടുള്ള കുട്ടികളിൽ ഉണ്ടാകുന്ന ചെറിയ വൈകല്യങ്ങൾ കണ്ടുപിടിക്കുന്നതിനും എയർലി ഡിറ്റക്ഷൻ നടത്തുന്നതിനുള്ള ക്യാമ്പുകൾ, അത് 16 ബ്ലോക്ക് പഞ്ചായത്തുകളുടെ നേതൃത്വത്തിൽ നമ്മുടെ ലോക്കൽ ബോഡീസിന്റെ ഭാഗമായിരുന്നു കുട്ടികളെയൊക്കെ പങ്കെടുപ്പിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് എയർലി ഡിറ്റക്ഷൻ ക്യാമ്പുകൾ ഞങ്ങൾ സംഘടിപ്പിക്കുന്നുണ്ടായി. പിന്നെ അതുപോലെ തന്നെ നമ്മുടെ അംഗൻവാടികൾ, ഒരുപക്ഷെ തൃശ്ശൂർ ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്തായിരിക്കും, ദേശീയ ഗ്രാമീണ തൊഴിലുറപ്പ് പദ്ധതിയെയും സാമൂഹ്യക്ഷേമ ബോർഡ് വകുപ്പിൻ്റെയും ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്തിൻ്റെ സഹകരണത്തോടുകൂടി 168 അംഗൻവാടികൾ, അത് ബാലസൗഹൃദമായിട്ടുള്ള അംഗൻവാടികൾ നമുക്ക് ഈ 5 വർഷക്കാലം കൊണ്ട് പണിതു കൊടുക്കാൻ കഴിഞ്ഞു. ഒപ്പം പഞ്ചായത്തുകളും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ മറ്റ് തദ്ദേശ സ്വയംഭരണ സ്ഥാപനങ്ങളും മെമ്പർമാരും ഒക്കെ അവരുടെ തനതായ ഫണ്ട് ഉപയോഗിച്ചുകൊണ്ടും ധാരാളം അംഗൻവാടികൾ പണിയുകയുണ്ടായി. അംഗൻവാടികൾ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് നല്ല കുടിവെള്ളം എത്തിക്കുന്നതിന് വേണ്ടിയിട്ട്, അതുപോലെ അവർക്ക് ശീതീകരണ സംവിധാനങ്ങൾ ഒരുക്കുന്ന കാര്യത്തിൽ, അതിൻ്റെ ഭൗതിക സാഹചര്യങ്ങൾ മെച്ചപ്പെടുന്ന കാര്യത്തിലൊക്കെ കോടിക്കണക്കിന് രൂപയാണ് നമ്മുടെ ജില്ലാ പഞ്ചായത്തും മറ്റ് തദ്ദേശ സ്വയംഭരണ സ്ഥാപനങ്ങളും ആ മേഖലയിൽ
മുടക്കിയിട്ടുള്ളത്. That's very good. This is precisely the message I wanted to convey by asking you this question. See, we have to move now to more greater integrated, area integrated projects at district level and so on. See, our interventions to have a big impact must be coordinated. So the district panchayats, in fact, should initiate, say, district-wide projects like the one you have now explaining, which everybody will join in certain common features. But then suppose a panchayat wants to go further and make it itself a model kuttikalda sauhrida panchayat, then they would have the freedom to do that. This kind of integration is what we have to move ahead in future. So that's very good what you have done. But before we move, I want to ask one question. Nammada katakada. Ee katakadayile ningal paranju anganavadiyude purva vidyarthi sangham undakkittundathu. Etra anganavadikku ingatha sangham undakkan kazhinjittundu? Adu pravartikkunnundo? അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു യോഗം മാത്രമാണോ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ തുടർച്ചയായിട്ട് കൂടുന്നുണ്ടോ?
സാർ പറയട്ടെ, കാട്ടാട ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്തില് 14 അംഗനവാടികൾക്കാണ് പൂർവ്വ വിദ്യാർത്ഥി സംഗമം ഉള്ളത്. അതിൽ ഓരോ സംഘവും അവരുടേതായ ഫണ്ട് ഉപയോഗിച്ച് ഓഡിറ്റോറിയങ്ങൾ, ചെറിയ ചെറിയ ഓഡിറ്റോറിയങ്ങൾ,
താങ്ക് യു. നൗ ഒരു ചോദ്യം നമ്മുടെ പെരാവൂർ. പെരാവൂർ പ്രസിഡന്റ് കണ്ടിട്ട് ഒരു വോളിബോൾ പ്ലെയർ ആണെന്ന് തോന്നുന്നു, ആണോ? ആണ്. സ്പോർട്സ് ആണോ നിങ്ങളുടെ ഏറ്റവും പ്രധാനപ്പെട്ട ഇന്റർവെൻഷൻ മേഖല?
അതെ.
അയ്യോ, വെരി ഗുഡ്. അപ്പൊ ഫുട്ബോളും വോളിബോളും?
ഫുട്ബോൾ വോളിബോൾ പ്ലെയറ് നമ്മുടെ ജിമ്മി ജോർജിന്റെ നാടാണ് പേരാർ പഞ്ചായത്ത്. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ജിമ്മി ജോർജ് സ്റ്റേഡിയത്തിൽ വെച്ചിട്ടാണ് അവർക്ക് നമ്മള് ട്രെയിനിങ് കൊടുത്തോണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നത്. അതുപോലെ വോളിബോള്, കളരി, യോഗ, നീന്തൽ പരിശീലനം ഇതെല്ലാം കുട്ടികൾക്ക് നൽകി വരികയാണ്. ഇത് കൂടാതെ തന്നെ നമുക്ക് സന്നദ്ധ സേവനത്തിലൂടെ കായികക്ഷമത പരിശീലനം നൽകുന്ന റിട്ടയേർഡ് സി ഐ കുട്ടിച്ചൻ സാറുണ്ട്. അവരുടെ നേതൃത്വത്തിൽ ഒരു 128 കുട്ടികൾക്ക് സ്ഥിരമായിട്ട് പരിശീലനം നൽകി ഒരുപാട് കുട്ടികളെ അവരുടെ കായിക ശേഷി വർദ്ധിപ്പിക്കുന്നതിനും അവർക്ക് സൈന്യത്തിലേക്ക്, മിലിറ്ററിയിലേക്ക്, അതോടൊപ്പം എക്സൈസിലേക്ക്, പോലീസിലേക്ക് എല്ലാം സെലക്ട് ചെയ്യാൻ വേണ്ടി സാധിക്കുകയാണ്. പിന്നെ ആർച്ചറി, ഇതെല്ലാം നമ്മുടെ മേഖലയിൽ എല്ലാ മേഖലയിലും കായിക ശേഷി വളർത്തിയെടുക്കുവാൻ വേണ്ട സാഹചര്യം പേരാർ പഞ്ചായത്തില് ഇന്ന് നിലവിലുണ്ട്.
What she has said is that Peravur is the place where the world renowned Hollywood player Jimmy Joes and their family, they are actually known for their commitment to Hollywood, and there they provide the support for Hollywood, football, and the all round development of children in varied sport activities including martial arts. So that is what the president said.
Gram panchayat president, ningade edavadalinte prathegathayittu enikku thoniyathu kuttigalde vyaktitva vikasanathilana kududalu unnil. The personal development of the children, that is the focus of your intervention. Now, has there been any visible impact upon the children, and do the parents appreciate it? Ramaburam president?
Minister Jovichada, ഈ രാമപുരത്ത് നിങ്ങൾ നടത്തിയ വലിയ പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങളുടെ ഭാഗം ഫലമായിട്ട് എന്തെങ്കിലും ഒരു വിസിബിൾ ആയിട്ടുള്ള ഇമ്പാക്റ്റ് ഉണ്ടോ? അത് പേരൻസ് എത്ര കണ്ട് അപ്രീഷിയേറ്റ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ട് എന്നാണ് ചോദിച്ചത്. രാമപുരംകാരോടാണ്
ഹെൽത്ത് ആൻഡ് എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ. ഒരു സ്റ്റുഡന്റ് ആണ് അഭിഷേക്.
എന്റെ പേര് അഭിഷേക് എന്നാണ്. മൈ നെയിം ഈസ് അഭിഷേക് നമ്പൂതിരി. ഐ എം എ സ്റ്റുഡന്റ് ഇൻ രാമപുരം ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത്. ഐ താങ്ക് ടു ഗിവ് ദിസ് ഓപ്പർച്യൂണിറ്റി ടു ഈ ഒരു സെക്ഷനിൽ എനിക്ക് പങ്കെടുക്കാൻ സാധിച്ചു, പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേറ്റ് ചെയ്യാൻ സാധിച്ചത് ഒത്തിരി നന്ദി പറയുന്നു. ഈ ഒരു ചോദ്യത്തിന് ഏറ്റവും വലിയ ഉദാഹരണം അല്ലെങ്കിൽ ഒരു ആൻസർ എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഞാൻ തന്നെയാണ്. ബിക്കോസ് ഞങ്ങളുടെ നാട്ടിൽ നടത്തിയ പല ഇൻട്രാക്ഷൻസ്, ആ ഇൻട്രാക്ഷൻസിലൂടെ ഒത്തിരിയേറെ സെൽഫ് കോൺഫിഡൻസ്, ഡിറ്റർമിനേഷൻ ഇതൊക്കെ കിട്ടിയത് കൊണ്ട് തന്നെയാണ് എനിക്കിപ്പോൾ ഈ വെബിനാറിൽ പാർട്ടിസിപ്പേറ്റ് ചെയ്ത് സംസാരിക്കാനായിട്ട് സാധിക്കുന്ന കോൺഫിഡൻസോട് കൂടിയിട്ട്. അത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ പേരൻസിനും അതുപോലെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ നാട്ടുകാർക്കും എല്ലാം ഒത്തിരിയേറെ ഇൻസ്പിരേഷൻ, ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒത്തിരി ഇൻസ്പിരേഷൻ, അല്ലെങ്കിൽ അവര് ഈ ഗ്രാമപഞ്ചായത്ത് നടത്തുന്ന പ്രവർത്തനങ്ങൾ കൂടുതലും മനസ്സിലാക്കി അറിഞ്ഞ് ഞങ്ങളെ ഇങ്ങോട്ടേക്ക് പറഞ്ഞു വിടുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് ഞങ്ങൾക്കും അതൊരു ഇൻസ്പിരേഷൻ ആണ്. പേരൻസിന് എല്ലാവർക്കും വളരെയധികം സന്തോഷം അഭിമാനവും നൽകുന്ന
കാര്യങ്ങളാണ്. The kind of impact of the interventions in Ramaburam Panchayat in terms of the overall development of the children, one of the children itself, he has responded saying that he himself is the testimonial for the visible impact of the interventions by the Rama Panchayat. He says that he has got confidence in terms of participating in this webinar and articulating his points. So I think this is a good answer to question by the minister.
So now we come to the last Kottakkal municipality. You are the only municipality in the whole presentations. Now you had presented the total amount of allocation for child-friendly activities. And I found it has been increasing by some 25% every year, from less than one crore rupees to nearly 5 crore rupees. That's very impressive. Now, what all components do you add in this, in the allocation for children? Quality, for example, claimed to 40%, which was in fact pointed out by from NIRD. Now, I can understand it's perfectly possible 40% be for the children-related activity, because if you add the allocation for, say, education, Anganwadi nutrition programs, and also for primary health care center, and so on, it can come up to that. So I would like to know, what is the definition that you have used for when you say the allocation that have been 4 crores in the last year? What of components have you added in there? You're speaking English. Yeah, fine. Chairman, samsarikkam.
Unmute.
അൺമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്തോളൂ. ലെഫ്റ്റ് സൈഡിൽ
കാണുന്നു,
കണ്ടോ? ആ മൈക്ക് അൺമ്യൂട്ട് ചെയ്യണം. അൺമ്യൂട്ട്, അവിടെ ആരെങ്കിലും ചോദിച്ചാൽ മതി. അൺമ്യൂട്ട്
പീറ്റർ സാർ
വിളിച്ചിട്ടുണ്ട്. കേൾക്കുന്നില്ല, അവിടെ ആരും ഇല്ലേ?
Okay, meanwhile, we have a guest who has been here, a special guest. Murdu Lipan, are you there? You want to say a few words?
Just lift your camera.
Mrudu, can you hear me? Would you like to say something?
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you now.
Okay. Yeah. So I really wanted to say how impressed one is, you know, and this is so important to show concretely what can be done, rather than, you know, talking in general terms. Everybody wants to know what can be done. And that is why I think this whole your series, you know, one after another, that's very, very important for me, because that is really what we want to know. But I want to say here something which Shobha just sort of, and all of you are mentioning, but you're not going deeper into it. And that is, see, from all the presentations, and some of them have been so innovative, we see that child friendly public spaces definitely have come up. There's no doubt about it. But my worry, and what has been disturbing one for the last few months because of certain cases being reported, is how to intervene in the family. That is my thing, and I think that's where somehow the panchayat should think of some methods where the families become child friendly, because the family structures are so much changing, you know. Single parent, then parents separated, then another step parent. So there are so many things happening within the family, and I think that's very important, and which is making the children very vulnerable. So outside, they're having a good for themselves, but inside the families, I think it's very important for us to intervene. That's what I really wanted to say, because there is something which has been very, very disturbing in the light of certain recent incidents that have been reported, you know, about abuse of children. So I think that's very important. So, and thank you very much for giving me this chance. And I think it's wonderful. You should go once, you know, each time something concrete should be shown to the, to the world.
ഹലോ സർ.
യെസ്, കോട്ടക്കൽ
മുനിസിപ്പാലിറ്റി. സർ, ഞാൻ കെ എം റഷീദ്. ജനകീയ ആസൂത്രണ കാലം മുതലുള്ളതാണ് മിനിസ്റ്റർക്ക് അറിയാം. ഞാനിവിടെ കോട്ടക്കൽ മുനിസിപ്പാലിറ്റിയിലെ വൈസ് ചെയർമാനാണ്, പ്ലാനിങ് ലോക്കൽ പ്ലാനിങ് കമ്മിറ്റിയിൽ. ഇവിടെ നമ്മൾ ചെയ്തത് എന്താണ് സാർ, മിനിസ്റ്റർ നമ്മുടെ ചെയർമാൻ ഇപ്പൊ ഇനോഗ്രേഷൻ പോയതാണ്, അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഇപ്പൊ പോയിട്ടേ ഉള്ളൂ, ഇതുവരെ ഉണ്ടായത്. അപ്പൊ നമ്മളിവിടെ സർവീസ് സെക്ടറിനാണ് ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ പ്രാധാന്യം കൊടുക്കുന്നത്, പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഭരണസമയം. അതുകൊണ്ട് ഇൻഫ്രാസ്ട്രക്ചറിൽ നമ്മൾ കൊടുക്കുമ്പോൾ നമ്മൾ റോഡ് മേഖലകളിലൊന്നല്ല, നമ്മൾ അധികം ചെയ്യുന്നത് സർവീസ് സെക്ടറിലാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഈ ഫണ്ടിങ് അധികം നീക്കി വെക്കുന്നത് അംഗനവാടിയുടെ റിനോവേഷൻ, അതുപോലെ തന്നെ ഈ സ്കൂൾ പിന്നെ ബിൽഡിങ്സ് അവരുടെ പിന്നെ കാര്യങ്ങൾ മാത്രമല്ല, ഇമ്മ്യൂണൈസേഷൻ, ഹെൽത്ത് സെൻറ്റേഴ്സ് ഇങ്ങനെയുള്ള കുറേ കാര്യങ്ങൾ നീക്കി വെക്കുന്നതുകൊണ്ടാണ് നമ്മൾ മൊത്തത്തിൽ ആ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് നേരിട്ട് കിട്ടുന്ന കാര്യങ്ങൾ നീക്കി വെക്കുന്നതുകൊണ്ട് നമ്മൾ 16-17 ഇത് സ്റ്റാർട്ട് ചെയ്ത സമയത്ത് 18% ഓഫ് ദി ടോട്ടൽ ഫണ്ടിൻ്റെ 18% അതിനുവേണ്ടി നീക്കി വെച്ചിരുന്നു. അതാണ് അതിൽ കൂടുതൽ എമൗണ്ട് അങ്ങനെ വന്നത്. പക്ഷെ ഓരോ വർഷവും നമ്മൾ കൂടിക്കൂടി വരികയാണ് ചെയ്യുന്നത്, കുറേ അല്ല ചെയ്യുന്നത്. അത് ചെയർമാൻ പ്രത്യേകം താല്പര്യം എടുക്കുന്നതാണ് ഇതിനുവേണ്ടി, കുട്ടികൾക്കും അതുപോലെ തന്നെ സർവീസ് മേഖലകളിലേക്കും കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി കിട്ടാൻ നീക്കി വെക്കുന്ന ഒരുപാട് കാര്യങ്ങളുണ്ട്. അതുപോലെ ഇവിടെ പ്രസന്റേഷൻ സാർ കാണിച്ചു കണ്ടിരുന്നു, അങ്ങനത്തെ കാര്യങ്ങളൊക്കെ പാർക്കുകളുണ്ട്, ഹെൽത്ത് സെന്ററുകളിൽ പ്രത്യേക അതിനുള്ള സൗകര്യങ്ങൾ ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്, അതിനൊക്കെ ഒക്കെ ആണ്. അങ്ങനെയുള്ള ഫണ്ടിങ് പ്ലാൻ ഫണ്ട് നീക്കി വെക്കുന്നു. അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ 32 projects 17-18 32 projects 30% അതിനുവേണ്ടി നീക്കി വെച്ചത്. പക്ഷെ അങ്ങനെ വന്നപ്പോൾ ഇപ്പം ഏറ്റവും കൂടുതൽ 52% എത്തിയിട്ടുണ്ട്, 52% വരെ എത്തിയിട്ടുണ്ട് സാർ. അപ്പോൾ മൊത്തം ഇതിൽ ഫണ്ടിങ് വരുന്നത് എങ്ങനെയാ വെച്ചാൽ സ്കൂൾ കെട്ടിടങ്ങൾ അതുപോലുള്ള പിന്നെ.
ഹലോ ഹലോ, ഒരു ചോദ്യം ചോദിക്കട്ടെ. 52% നിങ്ങൾ എങ്ങനെ 30% പ്രൊഡക്ഷൻ സെക്ടറിന് വെക്കണേ, ഡി പി സി എങ്ങനെ അംഗീകരിച്ചത്?
അല്ല സാർ, അങ്ങനെയല്ല, നമ്മൾ ഈ കുട്ടികൾക്ക് വേണ്ടി കിട്ടുന്നത് പ്രൊഡക്റ്റീവ് സെക്ടറിനും
മലയാളം. ദി വൈസ് ചെയർമൻ ഹാസ് ബീൻ സേയിങ് ദാറ്റ് ദേ ഹാവ് ബീൻ ഫോക്കസിംഗ് ഓൺ ദ സർവീസ് സെക്ടേഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് പർട്ടിക്കുലർലി ആക്ടിവിറ്റീസ് റിലേറ്റഡ് ടു ചിൽഡ്രൻ, എഡ്യൂക്കേഷൻ, റിനോവേഷൻ ഓഫ് അംഗനവാടീസ് ആൻഡ് സോൺ. And that's one important reason why there's projects which in some way would be linked to children have been rising. Now it is 52%, not just 40%, 52%. Of course, almost all projects in the education sector, Anganwadis, and you are saying, see, they have got to allocate 30% of the planned funds for production related activities. So now the children activities also will be linked to production, particularly say kitchen garden and so on and so forth, so that even the money which is allocated for the production projects would in some way be also linked to children. So children have been the focus of Kottakkal municipality. That's their choice, that's their choice. And you have some other panchayat who are going to give much more attention to geriatric care, and Kerala is shifting to that. beauty of decentralization is that it gives the freedom for local people to choose, and they have made this choice. I am happy to be here this evening to hear that, because I find here the panchayat exercising their freedom of choice is not something that is say regulator from above, you spend for this first and for that and so on. No, here are now local governments who are bold enough to make their own independent choice of how much to allocate for different sectors. I think we are at a close now because we have already extended.
If you permit, I think I have one question to Minister, sir. Can you permit, sir?
Yeah, please.
This is Kadirisan from NIRD, sir. I think this year, I think the 15th Finance Commission already given the guidelines 2 days before they circulated the guidelines, sir. I think in the 15th Finance Commission already 50% is tied funds going to sanitation and other things, something. What will be the overall impact, sir, in the overall impact in the local bodies, this 15th Finance Commission, as a Finance Minister, you'll be having some views, and I would like to listen from you, sir.
For Kerala, it is terrible.
Okay.
In fact, this is the supplementary memorandum that we have submitted to the Finance Commission. See, states like Kerala, where they have very long tradition of planning and total freedom for local government to choose. Now, if you put the Finance Commission's 50% has to be for sanitation, you are infringing upon the freedom of the local government. You should not do that. In fact, it creates a lot of problem for state planning, the planning in Kerala. Because, you know, our devolution consists of three components. One is the grant from the state government. Second is the devolution of the Union Finance Commission. And I mean, first is the grant from the State Finance Commission. Second is the grant from the Union Finance Commission. And then we have certain tied loans from World Bank and so on, explicitly for local government. Now, each source of finance is going to impose their own criteria for allocation of funds. Local level planning will become impossible. So this recommendation of the Finance Commission is totally retrogressive. They don't understand how things are going on at the local level, you see. And why should Kerala's planning process be derailed by this kind of intervention? I don't understand. I mean, suppose they should be sensitive to what is going on in different states. They have this notion of one hat fits all. really. So this is what we have been telling the Finance Commission. Last Finance Commission was gracious enough not to try to micromanage what should be done at the local level. Now, I don't know for what reason the new Finance Commission has brought them all back. I hope they have good sense will prevail, and the full report, they will remove this. And just think, now you have a COVID situation. This small amount of money, most of the local governments in India, they do not get any other than the Union Finance Commission grant. The money from the local, state governments are very paltry. And there is so much requirements at the local level in COVID times. I appeal that we made to Finance Commission was, given the COVID condition, remove all these restrictions. Give them freedom. Yeah, let them spend it they want. They have so many pressing needs in the village. So don't try to micromanage. That's my response.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the response.
Joy.
Actually, we have crossed all the time limits which you mentioned, but just a few comments and questions which you have come. Many of them have been covered during this time. Ramit Basu had actually posted a few questions, especially on the programs on domestic violence and all. I think it's already there on the various websites, especially the Kila website, where how the domestic violence during this period has been addressed. Then there is also comments from Sumita on the Kerala State for Children, a discussion on that. Probably it could be another webinar issue topic itself. And then we have Arjun, actually.
Hello? Already ready.
Okay.
Sir, quality ready.
Yeah. We'll come back. Vare. So, and then the Arjuna has actually asked whether is there any possibility for children during this epidemic to avail TV and connections and other things, which every local government in Kerala, with the support of all agencies, are doing now. So that, yeah.
In fact. Clarify this.
Yeah.
Now, our assessment is, and this is something fantastic, what local governments can do. Kerala government announces online teaching courses. And we find there are some 2.5 lakh children who do not have a smartphone or smart TV in their house. And within 1 week, almost all children in Kerala are provided with television at a common center. Common center means not keeping the COVID protocol. At a time, more than 4 or 5 children would be in that room to see that. Everything has been arranged by local government. Now something even more fantastic is going on. We are making an offer to every parent in Kerala. They can have, on installment terms, a laptop, something which would cost only 12,000 rupees or something. That would be sufficient for school children. The specs have been prepared for that. And since we are going to purchase in bulk, say 4 or 5 lakh laptops as people want, now this will be rolled out. You will have a situation where majority of the children in Kerala would have a laptop, which can be paid in as next 3 years. They are given the last time. Kudumbashri is managing that. See, this is what local governments do to increase the efficiency of the governance. You see, you have an emergency. The long arm of the government will never reach the far-flung villages of India, you see. But if you have a proper government over there, they can shoulder this responsibility. So when you ask this question, yes, this is, a very important example of how local government intervenes in a situation and provides for the emergency.
And a couple of comments also on the age, especially children now means up to 18. And hope you already heard that the Gram Panchayat is mentioning that it is not just 0 to 3 or 6, it's up to 18. And you have also seen the visuals where, up to 18-year-old children are also participating. This was posted by Akhila. And of course, she had also mentioned about the need for addressing second generation issues like mental health, substance abuse and all. A few of them have been already addressed in these presentations also, but others are also doing. There are other questions also, probably we will send it separately now so that the time is too late now. Thank you. And Joseph, for that. Thanks. You see. Okay. It has been a very interesting session and webinar, I would say. That is why people still sat through, even we overshot by almost 1 hour, but I think it was interesting for that. And formally, we, the organizers, the GIFT, Harita Kerala Mission, and Kila, thank Srimati K.K. Shailaja, teacher, the Honorable Minister for Health, Social Justice, Women and Child Development. Also the panelists, Srimati Shobha Koshi, Sri Balagopal, and Dr. Kadireshan. And you have been totally involved in this whole process, this webinar process. Thanks to all of you. Of course, the elected representatives, the officials of the local governments who have presented, Valapattanam, the Peravur, Kavaleri, Ramapuram, Katakada, Kottakkal, and Thrissur District Panchayat. Thanks to all of you for making this presentation. I know that we know that during this last 1 week, you have all been very active to get this done, especially during this COVID time where lockdown and all kinds of problems were there, still you managed. Thanks a lot. We have also pressurized you too much, I know, but thanks to all of you. And for all the participants who have been watching this, for all the participants, a big thank you. And then the team which worked behind in GIFT, in Harita Kerala Mission, and of course the IT team in Kila and the Child Resource Center in Kila, where Dr. Peter Raj and his team have been literally working day and night, and the young team who have been preparing, supporting him in Kila. Thanks to all of you. Next week, same time on Saturday, 2:30 to 4:30, we have a session on water and land management of a particular assembly constituency where 6 gram panchayats and 2 block panchayats come together and how they work together to work upon long-term results in water conservation and land management. So next week, 2:30 to 4:30, Saturday, I think it is 25th of July. Thank you all. Anything?
Kadireshan?
Nothing, sir. It was very wonderful, sir. Overall, it's
He was asking whether you have met him earlier.
No, sir. I